Always by my side, I gotta leave yours. Cause I got things I wanna do, I gotta see more. You know I love you, but I gotta do what's best for me. Man, I'm the greatest, and they not expecting less from me. I gave you all my tears, I swear you took the best of me. And I'd be damned if I let you take the rest of me. Haters who act like friends, they the worst enemies. Watch who I'm giving good news to, cause they envy me. And when they talk behind my back, are you defending me? Probably not, but the same person that depend on me. Seem as I'm growing every day, man, that's how cold it get. I wish my granddaddy would call me, cause he older. And if I lost you and we ain't talking, man, my soul is split. I gotta cherish what I got, can't get no more of this. Lord knows, it's a crazy world. I got my head on straight, so it ain't phasing her. They made me get up and grind, they made you lazier. To my father, they'll never take his baby girl. And I'm like, Lord knows, it's a crazy world. Got my head on straight, so it ain't phasing her. They made me get up and grind, they made you lazier. They took my father, they'll never take his baby girl. And I say, I don't need time, but time is all I got. I wanna be fine, but fine is what I'm not. You want me to read minds, and I don't see the thought. I gotta feed mine, so I've been on the clock. Like, lately, I feel like I've mind been in two different places.
In 2000, EST, OCOEE. I'm trying to take it higher than I ever been. They like, hello, how you mix the music with the medicine? Light on Thomas Edison. You don't know if you believe, look at my life, it's evidence. Look at my life, it's evidence. Kick the demons out, oh, you can't stay up in my residence. Jesus knocking at the door, so I had to let him in. Food for my soul, I don't gotta live by bread again. It's that 66, that old and new testament. Jesus, he the king, that's very different from a president. Said it, we believe it, we don't go, that's how we stepping in. Your word, that's the law, that's the code, that's what we following. No turning back, I'm falling in. Hold on, I'm falling in, don't do it.
Hey guys, hey guys, hey guys. We are back, we are back, we are back. LSU does have a matchup today versus Florida at 1 p.m. Central Time. We haven't been able to chat since our last game. So I wanted to come on an hour early today so that we can listen to some of the press conferences that's been out so that we can discuss. And then we're going to, of course, watch the official game. So I want to get into this interview first. I'm going to go ahead and get it started. And here we go.
Legend, Coach Kim Mulkey. Coach Mulkey, thank you so much for joining us today. Obviously, a rough day in the hump on Monday, and I want to start here. You get a lot of fascinating things to say after the game that I want to get into and kind of pick your brain on. But first, so much was made of that South Carolina game last Thursday. It was so well played. Atmosphere incredible. Had it right there until the very end. Do you feel that any of that bled over into Monday, or do you feel like Monday's result is independent of Thursday?
Well, I addressed it with my team after the South Carolina loss. And I said, the hardest game is the one after the quote-unquote big game.
Yeah.
Whether we had won the game or lost the South Carolina game, it's the next game that is always challenging. Why? Because it was so big, the adrenaline, the hype, and it's kind of like anything. You don't want to have a letdown, but, you know, physically you do. And so we addressed it. I don't want to use that as an excuse that we lost, because as we're learning with my team, you are getting everybody's absolute best game. I mean, they shot 83% in the third quarter. I don't know that I've ever had that in the history of my coaching or even playing. And you were still in the game. You still fought to the end. So it was an atmosphere in Starkville, sold out.
Yeah, it's crazy.
I find that just crazy that we are the team that everybody's selling out the arenas for. And yet I also view that as respect. I review that as we're growing the game. Why us, I guess, is the question. We're the defending national champions. We have a personality just about at every position on our team. We play exciting basketball. Hell, some of them even come just to see what I'm wearing. So I guess whatever it is that toots your horn, we have to embrace it and look at it as wonderful.
Coach, I was actually going to be my first question with you. What are the environments like this year compared to last year? Because, you know, last year, obviously, like you could tell, you're going to be one of the better teams in the country. But how much different are the atmospheres and the crowds? And, you know, everybody wants to always go out there and beat the national champion.
I said this to my former mentor or coach. He's my current mentor, is Leon Ballmer. I said, Coach, I've never seen anything like this. I said, I coached 40-0 teams, won 3 national championships before I got to LSU. It's just something you just go, what the heck is going on? What have we done? And as I just mentioned, I think it's all of the above and more. And it's good. It's welcomed. It's environments that young people wish they could, you know, years from now tell their children and grandchildren about. I just have never seen anything like it. I think every trip we have gone on and played on the road, guys, it's record-breaking crowds for that institution. And yep. Let's be honest, it's not them going to see just their own team play. It's because LSU's in town.
Well, I mean, even last Thursday, Coach, I mean, you got Kevin Durant tweeting about the game. You got some of the biggest basketball names in the world. Magic Johnson tweeting about the game and the environment. After the game on Monday, I found your post-game to be very interesting because you kind of had a lot of interlocking concepts, right, in terms of, like, okay, can't get stops when they matter right now. Is that a lack of experience? Does a lack of experience lead to a lack of leadership, a lack of chemistry, a lack of toughness, depth? Let's start with the experience portion of that. Is there a way? Well, go ahead. Sorry.
Listen, you just answered it. It's all of the above. And you've got new players who've not been in that environment for, you know, a long period of time. Wow, I can't take a play off. It's not that they don't want to win. It's not that they're not playing hard. It's just, wow, bam, just for that 2 seconds right there, they hit a 3 on me because I'm ball watching. Or bam, right there, I didn't help my teammate. And that's experience. I don't think the moment is too big. Believe it or not, I don't think the moment is too big. I did think that last year when we went to South Carolina and we were never in the ball game, that was a moment that was too big for many of them on my team. I think what it is that when you've not been in the environment and you don't understand, the experience plays a role and you want somebody else to do it instead of you doing it. And then you go to leadership. We lost so many good players last year to graduation that we're looking at each other like, who needs to lead us this year? You think it's a natural for Angel, but at the same time, you need more than just verbal leadership. You need somebody that's a great practice player that's going to give it to you every day. And then chemistry comes with time. Yeah. And honestly, other than Angel and Flage on that floor together, everybody else is learning to play together. And we don't have opponents that are going to be anything but at their best because of what we've done in the past and our personalities and the attention we draw. So people are bringing it, and you're going to have to adjust on the fly.
Yeah, and I can't help but be reminded about you know, the poem that you've referenced multiple times to us. You know, it's just one possession when it comes to getting some of those stops. But back on the experience thing, Coach, if a lot of that is the root that is seeping out into these other areas, can you manufacture experience? Like in the midst of a season, can you create enough experience by tournament time? Does that happen naturally?
Well, yes, you can. in the ideal world, I'd love to be going out there and there's a fourth year player. There's my fifth year COVID guy. That's what we had last year with new players. And it all just kind of started flowing together. Certainly you can. Let me put it like this. We can beat anybody in the country. You saw that. If South Carolina is the number one team in the country, we can compete with them.
Yeah.
And yet we can also get beat because of certain things we don't have yet. So there is so much basketball left to be played. Mm-hmm. We've got the second half of SEC in February. We've got the playoffs, and I'll leave it at this. We played South Carolina February 12th of last year, and we were embarrassed on national television. And then we come back and win the national championship.
Yeah.
So it's not that anything is broken. It's not that anything bad is happening. A lot of this is expected. If you've been in the business, oh man, defending the national champions, we need to go for repeat. No one thought at the time when they were saying those things that Samaya Smith, our starter 6'5", would get injured and be out for the year. No one thought about Kateri Poole not being with us anymore.
Yeah.
Things happen through the course of a year. And you have to, as a staff and as a program, you have to adjust. And that's what we're doing, and that's what we'll continue to do. And hopefully at the right time, hey, let's make another run at it. 6 games in the playoffs.
Could you talk about, like, you know, different situations, obviously, because this is a different team.
Six games and the playoffs. Well, there you have it from Coach Mulkey. I want to get into what's been called an epic press conference from her. It is 30 minutes. That's why I wanted to go live earlier, because I haven't had a chance to watch it to get any, like, timestamps of what, you know, I wanted to get to. So I do want to watch the full thing. I know we've been having a lot of comments. So what I'll do is I'll go ahead and copy the StreamYard link into the chat. That way, if anybody does want to come up. Can you guys hear me? Okay. Yep. So if anybody does want to come up, you guys can come up and speak while we're watching this, and I'll pause it. I know. I was so excited. I saw that the other day. And I've missed you guys so much. I told some of you guys before what I do, what like me and my husband do. We own an Airbnb cleaning company. And because it's Mardi Gras season, it's very, very busy for our company right now. So that's the reason why I haven't been able to get on here and really like stream and do the post games and the pre games like everybody has been wanting. Yes, we do play today. We play at 1 p.m. Central Time. I know I've been busy, but we're back. It's just Mardi Gras season. But listen, what I wanted to talk to you guys about is Go Tiger Hoops. I want it to be like a community channel. So if somebody wants to go live, if somebody wants to host a pregame or a postgame, that's certainly cool with me. I can send you over the StreamYard and you guys can host the live. Like, it's never, you know, something so big to me where nobody else can do it. I can always do a Zoom with you to teach you guys how. But anybody that is interested in hosting a pregame or a postgame, that's certainly cool. Thank you for streaming. Of course, we're not going to miss any games. We're not going to miss any games. But that's the thing. Like, everybody has said this. Let me go here. I feel like the bench should have got some experience during all those blowouts in the beginning of the season. And I feel like that is so true, because Kent could have played more. Barlett could have played more. Velez could have played more. Del Rosario could have played more. They all could have played more. Izzy could have played more. Why have a bench that we don't use, especially with everything happened? I know, Aaron. Thank you so much. Yes, Aaron, I did a Zoom with him. He was going to be able to stream today. So if you guys want to do like a post game or something, we'll see if Aaron has the ability to do that. And then again, he'll just be posting the StreamYard chat. Everybody can come up and talk. I don't think Velez is going to be ready this year either, because she didn't get enough time in the beginning of the year. I think I like Michaela Williams at point. Yes. So I watched a game. What game was it? It was a good game. It was like a shootout too. Number two. I'll have to see. But the point guard on that team reminded me exactly of Velez. That's how Velez hoops. She's a New Yorker. She's from the Bronx, I think. Like, that girl can hoop. Just let her get out there and get into her groove, get her confidence. I seen when it happened with Velez. It was in that Cayman Islands game. I remember it when I just seen her confidence go. And I didn't really see her get much playing time after that. So I hope she does get another chance. I really do hope. And what I was going to say to Velez, I was talking to my husband about this, is like, girl, closed mouths don't get fed. So if you really feel like you're ready to play, I see her on Instagram every single morning, 6, 7, 8 o'clock in the morning at the gym, using her 1% rule, saying, you know, I've got to get better 1% every single day. And I love that. I see a lot of girls on that team work very, very hard. So, in the middle of the game, when something happened, turnover, whatever, you feel like you're ready to play, get up, go to Kim on the bench, get from the bench, go to Kim, say, I'm ready to play. She may say no right there. The worst thing she could say is no, but I bet you if something else does happen, she'd be like, Velez, get in. And when it is your time to get in, make a play, make something happen. Like, don't leave the court until you make a play. You know what I mean? And then she'll give you that confidence to say, okay, I'm going to call on her again. I'm going to call on her again. So I feel like if the bench wants to play, get up in the middle of the game, act, something else happen, she may let you in. That's what I used to do. I used to play volleyball. Okay, let me get into this.
Hey, Coach. Obviously, with a couple of extra days between games, just how have you seen the team respond? And just overall, what's been your overall message of this week?
We took 2 days off after the Mississippi State game. And so yesterday was the first day to be back together. Spent a lot of time in the film room on looking at us. And fixing us. Today we will get back in there and do our report on Florida. Yesterday we did get on the floor and it was all defense, just worked on defensive stuff. And today we'll work obviously on Florida, but also defensive stuff.
What are you seeing? If it's defensive, what are you seeing? The stuff that we saw before?
Recordings just got better. Hey, it's Dana from StreamYard. I'm so excited to announce.
Just repetition on helping on the drives, how to cut angles to keep them out of the paint, talking, communicating a lot, helping each other, realizing that you're not on an island by yourself on the defensive end and that we all need to have a string attached to us and help each other.
Sorry, a little bit of a detour. Coming off the Mississippi State game, with so many of the road games this season being record-selling, like ticket sales or just sold-out games, what do you see in that economic impact, not just at LSU, but at the universities you're going to?
Well, let me make it clear. I don't know in the history of women's basketball that any program has ever made money. That goes back to my days of playing, Pat Summitt's days of coaching, Gino's days of coaching. So if you're looking at that, you don't need to be. What you do need to look at is what you just said, is the excitement that is out there now in the public for women's basketball. Certainly, it's personalities on my team. It's how we play. We are generating a lot of interest from last year, and you're getting those big crowds, which is great. And you're also getting teams that are just coming at you. I mean, playing awesome. And we've got to match that when we go on the road.
Coach, 8 games left, SEC tournament. Do you feel like you're getting to the realm where you can't afford another loss, and maybe does the SEC tournament all could matter more to you than you like to put emphasis on it in previous years?
What do you mean afford it?
Yeah,
what,
I mean,
if you lose another one, what does it do?
Being able to host,
you know. Oh, hosting?
Yes.
Oh, well, I don't know that. You know, I don't put I can't think like that right now. All I can think about is Florida. I can't sit and take the time to go, okay, if we do this and this, we should host, but then what if they do this? It's going to come down to the end of the season, however many people sit in a room and make the decision. Certainly we would love to host. Certainly we think we're worthy of that, but Lord knows I can't think like that. I couldn't think like that if I was sitting up here undefeated. You just think about the next opponent.
Kim, offensively, what are some of the things that you feel like you need to get better at right now? I notice teams are really pressuring your guards and taking a lot of your shot clock to get into your offense. What do you see?
Taking care of the ball. Getting us a good shot starts with getting the ball up the floor and then just making the simple passes. Get open on the wing. Yes, people are pressuring us. Deal with it. Learn how to handle that. Don't play faster because someone's pressuring you. Play with composure and get the ball where it needs to be. And, it's the best way I know to answer that. It's pretty simple. Make a pass, get open, make another pass, score the ball.
Yeah, Coach, obviously you guys are in somewhat of an unfamiliar position right now. Just being around the team since Monday, does it feel any different? Just the morale.
Well, are you talking about unfamiliar position because we lost two in a row or?
Yeah.
Because I've been in this position many times.
Well, this team in particular.
Well, I don't know because it's a different team. It's not the same team as last year. I don't know if Michaela Williams ever lost two in a row. I don't know if Haley Van Lith. I don't know. I don't view it that way. I view it as if somebody beats you, you make sure they do what they need to do to beat you. And I feel like both teams did what they needed to do to beat us. And then you address what you didn't do to win the game. Guys, we're 17-4. 18-4. Oh, are we? See, I don't even know. 18-4. One of the top teams in the country. It happens. We just go back to work and focus on the next game and focus on us and see what happens here late in the year.
Coach, against Mississippi State, we saw Janae get some early run. What did you see from her in the minutes she played and what kind of progress is she making?
I didn't see just something glaring at me, good or bad. So that could be, I guess, good. It's kind of like if you don't know a referee's on the floor, that must mean they call pretty good, right? Just trying to get the attention. I think she went in for Michaela, get the attention of Michaela on turning the ball over and giving up an offensive board, but also getting her attention. Are you in the ball game? Are you ready to go if I need you? So she got in late, too, on situations when Flage got in foul trouble and I was subbing offense and defense. So all those little things will help her.
Coach, she's only a freshman, but what is Velez learning and what is she working on to put herself in position to play more minutes?
Well, I think that's the first thing is she's not focusing on how many minutes that she is or is not getting. She's focusing on how do I get better to someday get on that floor. She understands it's a process. She keeps the right mind frame. She stays positive. She's encouraging. She's listening. She's asking questions. Of late, I have her defending Haley and Poa just because she can pressure the ball a little bit and I don't have to use big physical guys out there that are on our dream team.
Have you been suffering from the after effects of a car crash? The good news is you're still entitled to a...
Is she closer than we think?
Well, you got to understand, Haley and Poa are going to be the majority of the minutes. So I don't know that I can answer that she's closer than you think. She understands the pecking order.
You've talked before about feeding the beast, and, you know, you just mentioned your record and kind of the reality of where the team is, I guess. Is that a conversation that you've had with them? Don't try to be what people's expectations of you are. Last year's team, I think, had different expectations, and they were good at kind of blocking that out. This year's team, I feel like, has, you know, exceeded expectations upon them. and they're trying to live up to them. Is that realistic?
I think what I've talked to them about is you're getting shots from people that last year's team didn't get. You're getting crowds that last year's team really didn't get. It started snowballing, but you're getting a lot of all of these hits because of social media, because of defending champions, because of personalities. So you got to deal with it. Last year's team is gone. But that's not a bad thing. We don't view it as a bad thing. I view that as a good thing. And that means that we're doing things in the right direction if we're doing those kind of things, not just here, but on the road. We don't have last year's team, and what we thought we had, we don't have either. We thought we would have the depth, but you just keep on keeping on and keep on playing.
Kim, back to, I guess, the quartet of freshmen. When they got to campus, I guess, what did you immediately see out of Michaela that showed you or proved to you that, you know, she could be a day one starter out of that group? And I guess what was kind of maybe the difference in that assessment from her and the other three? And I guess what's the room to make up for the other three to be able to play more minutes for you guys?
Really, she wasn't here this summer as much as like Aaliyah was. Aaliyah was rehabbing an ankle that she had cleaned up. And so Michaela did a lot of her three-on-three USA basketball. Really, she was judged and observed when practice started and what she did in inter-squad scrimmages and what she did every day in practice. And I thought that Michaela and Janae, when we started practicing, I thought they really held their own. And you just evaluate what you have on that floor. Now, at that time, we had everybody. So as time progressed, you didn't have everybody. And so that's where some things had to change in my mind on substitution, on who started and all that.
Kim, the you said you worked on defense and stuff like that. Are you optimistic that those things can be improved, you know, to enough to help y'all, you know, win, you know, down the road?
Yeah. We're 18-4, Scott.
You keep coaching. I mean,
we're 18-4. Mm-hmm. Yeah. We're going to win some more games.
But improve to your liking, I guess it would say. As you've said, it's something to work on.
Everything improves with time. My problem is patience. I wanted it fixed yesterday or this summer. But you can't rush time. I have to be realistic in what they're really physically capable of doing on the defensive end. Is it knowledge? Is it effort? Is it maturity? And so I have to think of all those things as I watch film and I show them things. But I don't go in there bashing them and showing them everything bad that they do. I go in there and go, this is so much better than a month ago. Well, maybe in another month it'll be better than this month. That's what you do. It's just keep working at it, and it'll click one day. Will it click when I want it to? I hope so, but who knows?
Well, and would you consider anything kind of radical, like moving Haley back to a shooting guard position and having Poa
yes,
play most
yes.
of the point?
Yes, if Poa gets untracked, Haley's natural position is the off guard. And boy, if Poa gets untracked and can do that, absolutely. And that would give you three or four rotations on the wing. Certainly, absolutely.
Yeah, Coach, just looking at Florida, Correa averaging 26 a game off the bench.
Leading the conference, isn't she?
Yeah, you could just talk about
in
her.
In SEC, man, she can score some points. Without having done the full scouting report with the team, just off the top of my head, you better get back in transition defense. Don't look at their win-loss record. I think it can be misleading. They've been in some games. They've lost some heartbreakers. And we've got to defend. We've got to defend in transition. We've got to defend in the half court. And I'm sure they're going to do what they do, and that is play man-to-man, but they'll also press you some. So we'll have to work on those things. But that's nothing that we don't work on for every game. It's good to be back home. It's good to lick your wounds at home and see if you can't get that home court feel and get you going a little bit and get your spirits good. But our spirits aren't bad. I mean, you don't drag your head because you got beat by two pretty good teams on the nights we played them. What you drag your head about or duck your head about is, ugh, I wish I could do that over. Oh, I wish I could do that over. That's basketball. That's sports.
Coach, about what time do you want your players to arrive at the arena? I noticed the last home game in the 4 o'clock hour, your guards were shooting threes, 5 o'clock, 6 o'clock, especially when you're playing so few players. And also, do you have to worry about on even taking 2 days off? Do you have some self-starters who might want to overtrain and go work even though they had the day off? You have to watch that.
That's a fine line, yes. Having the bye week is why I gave them 2 days off. Now, I don't tell them they can't get in a gym. I don't tell them anything like that. I do know that I have coached players that sometimes they overwork themselves, especially the day of a game. And I've addressed that with several of them because it's not just here. I've even at Baylor before told one of them, don't come in this gym. I don't want to see you in this gym. I'm going to check the, we check the little finger scan. No. Isn't that great? As a coach, you have to tell a player that. Most of the time, it's like you can't get them to work out. I don't have that problem. Not at LSU, and I've never really had it in my coaching career. So it is a fine line between what are you doing in your individual workouts on your own when we're not here? Is it tiring you with the minutes some of you have to play? Do you need that? So we've had those discussions just to make them aware of, evaluate your performance in a game and think, what did I do different? What can I do better? So, yeah, you have all those kind of conversations, or I do.
Ah, online shopping. A frustrating journey filled with vanishing carts.
You're honoring Sue Gunner on Sunday. What is that going to mean for the program? What's it going to mean for her and her family to have that officially recognized?
Reed, I'm not honoring her. This university is honoring her. I'm just a small part of it. For me personally, it's just somebody from afar that I respected when teams I was a part of competed against her teams, whether it was at Stephen F. Austin or LSU. So it's going to be especially wonderful for Bob Starkey and those 100 alums that are coming back, and I would think most all of them played for her except the last, era that she was not coaching here. So it will be, I would imagine, emotional for some of them. But I think it'll be more joyous because I think they're very proud of what we're doing. I think they were proud when they played here, saw a little lull, and now hopefully when they come back and they see the crowd, they'll go, wow. And that's what I'll be watching is just happiness.
Yeah, Kim, most of the time when teams get on runs against y'all, 10, 12, 14 points, you try to let your team play through it instead of calling timeouts. Just what's your philosophy on that? And when do you finally say, I got to call a timeout?
My philosophy is to save as many timeouts as I can for the end of ball games in case you need them. I've thought about that through the course of the season. Do I need to call more because we're not playing that many players and it gives them an extra rest? Sometimes media timeout is coming up, and do I really want to use my timeout if I'm going to get the next dead ball timeout with a media timeout? So all those things go through your mind. I don't know that I've made the right decision or wrong decision through the course of the season, but certainly you have to make adjustments. I can think of games where I used my timeouts too early and I needed them late in the game and I didn't have them. And then I can think of times where I had timeouts left and I never used them. You just have to go with a gut feeling.
Got time for a couple more here. Cobbleman.
Can you help me understand the help defense and where it's going wrong? Is it helping the helper or?
It's all of it. What's the hardest thing in basketball, men or women, to do on defense? What is it? Stop dribble penetration. I don't care who you are. If I have the ball in my hand, I'm usually going to win that dribble penetration. It's just the way it is. So the guy guarding the ball has to keep them out of that paint area and channel them to a sideline. When they don't, that's where your help has to come from. Now, that depends on where the opponent's players are positioned. Does it need to come from Angel and our post players, Morrow at the high post? We could have done really, really a lot more from that position in the Mississippi State game, because what they did is they spread the floor on you over here. Well, you don't want to help ball side dribble penetration because they're just going to kick it out. So it's who needs to help, when you need to go, how do you anticipate going? When you're fleet of foot in all sports, it covers up a lot of mistakes. If I get beat and I'm a safety, boy, I can truck it and get back there before that ball is completed. But if you're not fleet of foot, you have to angle yourself in such a way where you don't get beat. And I think that's a lot of it. And then when we do get beat, am I anticipating something right or wrong, or am I just standing flat-footed? And when I do go, can I make something happen, like take a charge? Well, if you take a charge and you don't get it, they're usually going to call a block. It does what? It stops the clock, which is a heck of a lot better than them kicking it out for a three. So it's just learning all those little things that can make us better defensively. Communicating is the biggest problem. We don't communicate at all five positions at the same time. And I can't read your mind and know what you're going to do unless I've played with you for a long period of time. I can't tell you in 3 months of playing together where you really like to get the ball the most. But I can if I've been playing with you a year, 2 years. I know what makes you tick. So you're trying to do it as fast as you can. And we are improved, but we're not there yet. Will we get there this year? Guys, I can't answer that. I hope so, but I don't know that it'll be a polished product, but I think we can get there to win ball games, to go deep. I'll ask you this. Scott, when you sat here in February after you went to South Carolina, didn't you? When you came back, did you think that team was going to win a national championship? That's all I need to hear. So all these detailed questions you ask, I can't give you the perfect answer or the absolute answer. That's why this sport is so dang fun. Who knows? Who knows? But that's one thing I'll tell you. We're relevant. We're playing for it. Keep perspective.
No offense, but if you still think stocks, real estate, or crypto are the best passive income investments in today's economy, I'm sorry, but you've got it wrong. There's a little known trend attracting millions of dollars a day right now.
You kind of talked a little bit about economics at the beginning. There were some numbers that came out about last year that got some people's attention in terms of your program. Are you a believer that there's certain things, like when you play in a national championship game in front of 10 million viewers, that's millions of dollars of free advertising, memories, so forth, strengthening brand? I mean, what are your thoughts on that?
All right, get your pens out. I'm a bean counter by nature, right? I used to almost major in accounting. If you're an investor, you're just going to do away with women's sports. rid of women's sports because we're not making money. But there's a lot of ways to invest in a corporation that brings you value. What we're doing and a lot of programs have done through the years is bring a dollar value on that TV that you can't just put a pin down and tell you how much that cost or how many students decided to go to LSU and pay money because they saw you on TV. Or those are the things that you just don't put on a paper when whatever you're talking about is released. So I am a firm believer that LSU is getting a return on investment with what they have invested in our program. And not just our program, but programs across the country. Yeah, I'm gonna stop at that unless you have another question. When you're dating somebody, do you just judge them by how they look? Nah. No, that's exactly right. If you just want to go, they lost this, this, and this, get rid of the program. That's not happening. It does not bring in my value to this institution in so many ways. The speaking engagements, the amount of money raised, the amount of people who now buy these tickets to come to games. There'll be a great crowd again Sunday for whatever reason. And I don't want to use me, but I'm the leader. And if we're not putting a product out there and there's nobody in the stands and we're not out there selling the program and we're not being on television and we're not being talked about, you're not getting a return on investment.
But if your fundraising number was included in that, do you think you'd be closer even than people would imagine?
If what?
If you're fundraising to the TAF, where people are writing checks to the TAF, that number's not in that bottom line.
Well, you're asking somebody to answer it based upon what I feel like we're doing. You've got those that do clickbait. It works. 12, 13,000, and but Corey, that everybody finds that niche within their institution so that it's not just one sitting on the court. Then we move to the assembly center and major stations. You're seeing every institution, but I can tell you I've watched men's games that don't have people in the stands either. So why?
Okay. So there we have it. Coach Kim Mulkey's latest press conferences, insight into how she's thinking right now. 6 games in the championship. Still going to keep HVL at point guard, Poa as her backup, and just keep pressing more on defense. One more video I want to watch before we get to
the game. Tell me
about
your neighbors. They're black.
And I didn't watch this yet either.
There she is.
Welcome back.
Let me see if she...
You're the Hall of Fame coach.
Watch live TV like cable with YouTube TV. Try it free. Terms apply. Cancel anytime.
Angel Reese wanted to get coached by Tuffley. Rotation entry post say the post player might
be else. Okay, so I'm not gonna watch that right now. So what do you guys think LSU needs to do to save the season? Or are you more with a Coach Mulkey mindset of like, everything is fine, guys? We've lost 4 games. You know what I mean? It's not that huge of a deal. It's something that she expected. I remember her saying before the Colorado game that she did not expect to win every single game this year. And she kept saying, I don't think we're going undefeated. Let me bring up the game. came. Okay, so I commented the StreamYard link. I'll go ahead and open up the chat. We have 15 minutes till the game starts, so now I'll just bring it into like a... Let me see. Okay, cool. So got all that set up. If anybody wants to come up, you can. I want to see the freshmen play. Which freshmen do you want to see play? Okay, so this conversation in the chat right now is about Flagey being the next best option for point guard for LSU right now. So the question right now is, what does LSU need to do to save the rest of the season? What changes would you guys like to see? Hi, Zeke. Welcome up. You can unmute yourself when you're ready. So you guys would want to move MK to the bench already? You can just feel the uncomfortableness. As soon as Haley brings up the ball, everything just feels disjointed. I think the pressure of being the point guard is just too much for her. She thrives in the shooting guard position. Zeke, you are up here. You can unmute yourself when you're ready. HVL would have to come off the bench. I just don't think Coach Mulkey is ever going to do that. Well, I remember when I got torn down my throat for saying the same thing, but hey, y'all know how the chat do sometimes. Zeke, you are still up here, so you will need to click unmute on your end to be back here. Hello, hello. Hello, hello. Flagey could be a point guard. Somebody said she's already played point guard before, too. I don't think Mulkey's going to make that switch. I know. I just feel like based on what I've heard, and I was thinking that we were going to hear something maybe a little radical, you know, big changes coming for LSU in that 30-minute press conference, but it didn't sound like that to me. It just sounded like what I'm doing is working. It doesn't work in some games, but those games we only lose by a little, so it is still working. We just need to do some more defensive things. It's not that, you know, her as the point guard is not working. It's just the defense is giving up a three here or not helping here. I know, girl. Same here. K Kim Mulkey said if Poa steps up, she would consider shifting HBL. So what I said from that is, what does she mean by Poa steps up? She didn't say less turnovers for her, more threes for her, more shooting, more this. She didn't say that. I think Poa should be starting one, and she makes plays on defense. That's what we need. But sometimes, and this is the thing, for weeks when we were in our regular conference, she kept saying, our offense is great. Our offense is great. We can shoot the ball. We can make plays. We can. And then we've been outscored in our last few games. So now it's like, okay, it's not just defense. It's offense as well. Zeke, I can hear you now. Are you able to speak? Hello, welcome.
It was good.
How are you doing?
I'm good.
Good. What would you like to say? You have the floor.
We just hope we had a good, hopefully we have a good game.
Yeah, we need a good game. So I've been seeing y'all say that about the transfer portal and people leaving LSU. Well, I guess we'll have to see what happens. You guys think Janae? I've been seeing Velez may go. I think I was hearing rumors about like the bench being cleared. But I know we've gotten some players to commit for next year. I think Sarah Strong's still out. Jada Richards is still out. Because I try to recruit those two. Nobody has left LSU. Nobody has left LSU. Except for Kateri Poole no longer being with us. So did y'all see Alexis Morris Instagram post? Because I saw Trill Hoops had posted about it, made a video about it. Let me see what they tagged us in. Yeah, give her a chance. I probably can't post that to my story yet. Let me see if it's up here. You're still up here if you would like to say anything.
So I wanted to say.
Okay, cool. Well, thank you so much. We'll be watching the game soon. At 12:55, I'm going to, this is what she had posted. When you lose, you don't lose when you fall. You lose when you stay down. Be very careful with me. Y'all miss me? Logging back off. Luther. And the comments was in shambles. You could take it two ways, but honestly, the girl played her, like, I've watched the last season's games. Alexis Morris was a dog. She had something inside of her that was like, I refuse to lose. I'm going to put up 20 points in front of you, and you're just going to have to do something about it. Even in the national championship game, that fourth quarter, like, Alexis Morris put that game on her back. There was plenty of games in the season where she said, we're not losing. So if you guys want her to not say anything at all, be better. I think her jersey should be retired at LSU. I do. Like, that girl played. That girl played. She has to have credit for how she played. She did her thing. So you think it's a chemistry issue?
Yes.
And like just her energy, that girl has a dog spirit inside of her. So even on the court, like I heard y'all be saying this in the comments, y'all be like, Haley, shoot the ball. Remember when Angel said that last game?
Mm-hmm.
So that is also funny. Poa liked it. Yeah. Strengths and weaknesses. If you know, Michaela Williams is weak in picking the person off the dribble, then the next person needs to know when to pick up, double team. Alexis knew how to feed all the stars. That's the difference. Lex different. Morris managed the team really well. She was crucial. Alexis knew how to feel everyone. Alexis, fast and shifty. Alexis is that girl. She just was, like, just her energy. Ugh. Yes, she is mess. Yes, she's mess. Yes, she is. And I'm not going to say nothing outside of that. Okay, make Alexis an assistant coach and hang up her jersey. Yes, I know, LaDeja Williams. She's a vibe, Luther. I'm not mad at that. Make Alexis an assistant coach. I know she's overseas right now, if I remember. Team chemistry comes with knowing each other's strengths and weaknesses. I will say this. I've said it before, but I will say it again. Whatever happened at the beginning of the season, I don't know if we're still seeing the effects of that. Something happened where Angel was gone for 4 games and Kateri Poole is no longer with the team. Something happened when the mothers got on Instagram and it was posted everywhere. Something definitely did happen. So because we don't know, and I'm not saying that that information ever needs to be shared, I'm just saying that we still have to take into account whatever happened could be playing an effect now. Even though we were told, you know, it's all over with and everybody's back together. Yeah, and like they said, this is not just everybody coming for you for a national championship. People are coming for Angel Reese because that girl's rich and famous. People are coming for the team because of the media exposure or this or that that's happening with them girls too.
Right.
Yeah, and you can tell when you're about to lose and it's only a few minutes left, you don't see that let's hug together, let's pull together, and let's win this game.
Because usually people be talking trash about LSU.
Oh, gosh. Flajay and Angel have unfollowed each other. Poa and Anissa don't follow each other, so it's definitely a lot going on. Guys, this is... And I think... And who knows? I have an unpopular opinion. Hire Alexis Follows and Simone and take some people off the staff that's not helping the players. Miley has been making terrible decisions for this season. We get all the attention. And there's also some documentary. Let me see. I think it was called LSU NIL documentary. Yes. And let me clock that real quick because we didn't get to talk about that before. This right here. And let me go to that Twitter post. Because the amount of hate that these girls receive from WNBA players, from people from other, it's disgusting. Why do y'all hate them so much? And as soon as they lose, oh, I guess the money didn't make you win. I guess the fame didn't make you win. You sound like a hater. Because as soon as I lose, you bring up, I guess you ride in the BMW for no reason. Like, girl, what? Like, hater energy. Loser energy. Oh my gosh. What's that page? I think I did. Is it J Clutch? Jakira? Yeah, I know. Okay, J_clutch2. You can have D. Right here. And you can't argue with her. LSU is the most hated women's college basketball team. The WNBA players don't root for them. The college players don't like them. LSU brought attention and eyes to women's basketball last year, and all y'all see is cocky girls. No, they're unapologetic, and y'all don't like it. And I saw this. There was so many players of just came out the woodworks as soon as LSU lost to, like, laugh and kiki and say y'all lost and y'all money don't matter and da 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 da. It was so weird. It's been real weird on the internet, but everybody's been exposing how they feel. But yeah, so Prime Video to release NIL docuseries on LSU, Dunn, Reese, and other Tiger stars. It's also going to include Flajay Johnson and then Jaden Daniels, who was the quarterback for LSU football. So that news was released. And remember when I told y'all, when you're a woman and you're around, like, just energies have trouble intermeaning if you guys really don't like each other, for real, for real. If there's something y'all haven't spoke about, if there's something that happened. Okay, give me your cup, baby. Mommy's about to stream, okay? Okay, it's 1 o'clock. Let me get the game going. We'll talk after. Thank you for coming up. I'm going to take you down now. Too much tension. Hopefully we don't see that. Only 4 losses, y'all say chemistry. Okay, I respect that. Hey, my LSU fam. Hey. Yeah. And they gotta make it work. So here we go. Let's get started soon, guys.
TNT.
Stands out as she has been pacing the way for the Gators in SEC play through 7 games. She leads the conference in points per game, and she has certainly shown off what she could do lately.
Well, she's coming off the bench. Are you kidding me? She loves to sit there, analyze, take everything in, really get a visual breakdown of what's going on.
Okay, here we go, guys. Game will be starting very, very shortly. Remember to hit the like, subscribe, share it with a friend. Donations are welcome. Be very, very positive in the chat. Let's support this team. We know they need this bounce back win. Here we
go. Off the bench, she had 3 straight 30-point games or better, and she is leading this Florida Gator team from the bench as Angel Reese in the white uniform for LSU and Faith Duke in the black for the Gators, and Haley Van Lith and the Tigers off to the races quickly, and on the opening tip, it's Tiger basketball with 2 points.
Yeah, that didn't take long.
Well, you had to think that this group coming off of that big game against South Carolina last week, and then also Mississippi State on the road, back-to-back losses, doesn't happen very often. With Kim Mulkey's group, they are going to be charged up.
Yeah, and Tiffany, it doesn't. And they have the scoring power, and you'll see right off the tip, they get it, go. Angel Reese runs to the rim, easy bucket.
All right, Birdie Rimdahl for the Gators, leaves it short, Mora. And back the other way is Haley Van Lith. Playing point guard this season, used to playing off guard in her previous institution in Van Lith. We know that she can score and leaves that one just short.
Yeah, that's one of the reasons why she came to LSU, to learn from Kim Mulkey from the point position.
Mulkey, a great point guard herself back in the day at Louisiana Tech here for the Gators, coming in at 2-5 in conference play, but this is a group who is feeling encouraged as a double dribble, the turnover there for the visiting Gators.
And so Tiffany, Florida can't afford to have those kind of unforced errors. They've got to have the opportunity to score the basketball, and they need to be deliberate, move the ball side to side, get a, not a good look, a great look at the basket.
Michaela Williams, the excellent freshman on the starting lineup for the Tigers, into Angel Reese, the All-American, who's off the mark. Faith Duke comes up with the rebound. Duke, along with Layla Reynolds, the freshman, with the ball in her hand, and hands it over to Jariah Warren in the first 2 points for the Gators.
Nice, and those are that's a great look, a transition look in the open court, gives the Gators an opportunity to score an easy basket.
Sophomore guard, Blanche Johnson, loses the handle there and then picks up the quick foul, trying to recover it. And the second team foul going against the Tigers. Kelly Ray Finley in her third season as the head coach of the Florida Gators, and a great motivator as a coach that she is, and really is just trying to pull the best out of this group, knowing that, hey, Aaliyah Matharu, we could see her, but she's been sick the last couple of games. Rashea Kyle, who is out, not sure of her return.
You know, she's had to really pull this team together the last really 2 years because of injuries and sickness, and so she's done a great job. Came up from the assistant coaching ranks, and so she's paid her dues, and now has done a great job at Florida.
2-2 ball game with nearly 3 minutes gone by. We speak of Matharu, and she's checking in now for the Gators. Number two in black, the senior out of Washington, D.C., is going to pick up full court against Haley Van Lith. Flage Johnson inside and couldn't finish there. Matharu off the right side comes across, and Matharu trying to get into the shooting rhythm early and does so. So immediately looking for a shot, but she leads the team in points per game at 18.
She does. I mean, great defensive series that led to an offense. And in transition, LSU really wasn't matched up and got her chance to get an easy shot.
Kayla Williams tried to answer back the other way. Off the mark, Murrow slow to get up underneath the basket. Again, numbers and losing the handle. Lith comes up with it. And Michaela Williams, the behind-the-back pass, and a turnover. We'll welcome in those of you on the SEC Network into Baton Rouge, Louisiana, the ninth-ranked LSU Tigers looking to put the last two losses in the rearview mirror. There was a no panic that we heard from Kim Mulkey before the game about just this group and where they are. She said, hey, let's put this all in perspective.
Absolutely.
We're 18-4 on this season. We're fourth in the rankings in the SEC. We're still doing all right. We got 8 games to play.
Absolutely. Well, they have the big game, South Carolina game, and you lose at home, and you're going to have a letdown. And so they go to Mississippi State, and they get all Mississippi State, a great game for Mississippi State, and they had two losses, and so we're going to see today how they bounce back.
Florida Gators, on the other hand, trying to ride Aaliyah Matharu in the good rhythm that she had. Well, this is a group that didn't see her on the court the last couple of games, including that last win against Texas A&M.
Well, yeah, she's gives them a little offensive punch. She's a great leader for them. She's a great defender. So they need her on the floor.
You talked about just the response that you mentioned from Coach Mulkey and how they would bounce back after, you know, that big game against South Carolina. Everyone was tuned in there. Mississippi State, they took their best shot in here. She says, what we did was we focused on us. As Angel Reese is fouled on the way to the basket, we focused on us because that's the most important thing that we could do. We had a bye week, so we took a couple of days off.
Yeah, well,
and got ourselves together.
It's not the end of the world that LSU lost two in a row. Right. It's a learning opportunity, and they had a chance to rest mentally, physically, and then work on the things that they need to. And Kim talked a lot about the defensive end. Look, that Mississippi State shot 52%. You're not going to win a lot of games if you allow your opponent to shoot in the 52% range.
And Angel Reese knocks it down. 3 points now for Reese, who we mentioned leads the SEC in points per game. Leilani Correa, we featured her in the open and how during the seven games in SEC, she has been red hot. Flajay Johnson trying to go to work. The crafty guard pulls up. No good. Anissa Morrow working hard on the board. And that's one area where LSU excels. They get down and dirty on the glass.
Well, Florida has any chance of really winning this game. They cannot allow LSU to get second chance opportunities. And LSU is unbelievable on the boards.
Stolen away by Matharu, and the smaller Matharu throws it up. And off the mark, last tier Poa in the backup point guard over to Michaela Williams. And Williams over, so sweet.
Ooh, I love her jumper. She makes it look so easy. Is she a freshman?
Yeah.
That's crazy.
Hey, look, eight games in now, the back half of the season, freshman no more.
Oh, my goodness.
In the SEC, I mean, we've seen her come alive. Remember, she had that 42-point game earlier in the season as bodies fall on the floor.
Yeah, and so you'll see Williams. They find her. She just takes a little shot, pulls up. How smooth is that? Just smooth, makes it look easy.
Michaela Williams out of Bossier City, Louisiana, number one ranked recruiting class, one of four freshmen on this team. But she's been placed into the starting lineup because of some of the changes. We saw Samaya Smith go down, a player earlier this season who was contributing, and then another player dismissed from the team. And so Michaela Williams finds herself in a great opportunity, and she's been showing off exactly how good she is.
Well, you know, you always want to play, and as a freshman, it is tough to come in, but she's not missing a beat. And each game, I think she gets better and better to me. She's just becoming, they're relying on her. She shoots the open jumper, and she's making it look easy right now.
Zippy Broughton, one of the veterans on this team, as Rindall well off the mark, the air ball into the hands of Morrow, who brings it up. Morrow, who's got good ball handling skills, dips it off to Flajay Johnson. Oh, baby, that gets the crowd excited as a 10-0 run from the home Tigers.
Yeah, you just can't. They're on a roll right now, and Flajay just wide open, making it look easy from the three-point line.
When are sports more than sports? When your highlight reel
Hey guys, what y'all thinking so far? First time out break, media break. What kind of vibe y'all want to do for the music today? I love those TikTok videos. Big four, but give her three. Hey, hey, hey. What music should we play? Big four replay. Okay. Literally crying. Where my prayer warriors at? Where is my Barb's at? They said they want to play. They want me to, like, don't. Guys, I tried to get JT do song Sideways, but it's not the clean version. I really like Sideways by JT. They look good. I think they got their bind right. Poa came in and got two back-to-back assists. Crank some Boosie, bruh. Hey, Glock never jammed. That's what we need, Meg. Thank you for the stream, of course. Poa only turned up. Well, I guess Poa doing better, guys. I didn't play it, guys, but I can. The game is back just now.
In the SEC are featured in this game, led by Angel Reese, pacing the league with close to 20 points a game. You see those Gators crunched in there, and Malia Matharu and Leilani Correa, along with Anissa Mora on the other side for the LSU Tigers. So if you like offense, well, it's great because they're great at doing it.
Yeah, you're on the right. You're at the right game because there's going to be a lot of offense, a lot of opportunities to score some baskets.
And we saw the flurry of scoring from LSU. They've scored 10 straight points here at the media timeout. And Angel Reese with three, Flaje Johnson with three, along with Anissa Morrow, and Michaela Williams leading the way with four. So out of the break, and you see the intensity. This is what Kim Mulkey wants to see. She wants to see the defensive intensity, the edge, and getting into their faces. And what does she say about how to defend? Not necessarily fleet of foot, as you mentioned, right, in terms of the guards, but what do they have to do?
Well, just basic, getting down in a stance, stay between. Here's how elementary it can be. Stay between the ball and the basket. And, well, that series right there shows that they can do it.
And when you look at Kim Mulkey on the sideline, she was clapping up. Very much excited about just that's the type of energy that she wants to see. And she says, hey, it's going to take some time for it to click. It's still a work in progress, but it's something that already has been taken to heart in the first several minutes of this one.
Yeah, she understands that in order to win games, win championships, of course you got to score. But you got to rebound the basketball, and you got to play defense. Those two things have got to go along with your scoring punch.
Reese finds Morrow on the elbow, and she's able to knock it down. 12 unanswered points from LSU. Matharu coming down the lane, and Reese, who averages a double-double, snatches down that rebound.
She's a rebounding machine, just a rebounding machine.
You think of the rebounding machine, she also gets the free throw line early and often. But also, I love the recognition that she had here, finding her teammate.
Yeah, she's drawing two defenders, and when she draws two defenders, she found the open player and makes it look easy. So very smart, not trying to force things, sees the double, kicks it out for the easy basket.
Best in the nation of getting to the free throw line and making those attempts. And Angel Reese out of Baltimore, Maryland. Boy, she has certainly helped to elevate the game of women's basketball as we see. It's in fantastic hands. She's repping the South, though. You know, you got Juju Watkins in the West, and Paige Beckers in the North, and Caitlin Clark in the Midwest, and Angel Reese is locking it down here in the South.
Well, she plays the game hard, and a lot of people may not like some of the antics she does. You know what? Throw that out. She plays hard. She plays with passion, and she makes the Tiger team go.
Great defense once more, but then they hand it right back over to the Tigers, and it's going to be Florida basketball. Michaela Williams checks out, takes a breather. So it's Van Lith, Morrow, Reese, Poa, and Johnson on the floor. Meanwhile, Kelly Ray Finley's group is down by 10 on the road. How do you inch your way back into this one in the final 3 minutes of this opening quarter?
Well, when the shot's not falling outside, you got to get some easy looks. Got to try to get inside, but Angel Reese makes that really difficult.
Talking about making it difficult on cue, her ears were burning. And Reese got a piece.
Yeah, you're driving to the basket, Reese. Not in my house. Not in my house.
Good look again there from Reese on the block. But you have to credit Matharu for being fearless and going in there.
Well, you got to attack them. You got to attack the lane. You got to loosen it up a little bit. Reese has a tendency to get in foul trouble.
And Johnson blocks that one away, and it kicks into the hands of the Gators. And Rimdahl, who's an excellent three-point shooter, is able to knock it down. So much needed points there for the Gators.
Yeah, they needed that. It kind of broke the ice for the Gators. They hadn't scored in a while.
Morrow being challenged by Correa. She's fouled.
I'm not sure why everybody in the comments are commenting that you guys are having issues seeing the game. The game is on.
The next one will send.
I'm watching it right now. I've been watching it since tip-off. So, Miss Linda, you may need to go out and come back in. Anybody else that's having an issue with seeing the game, go back out and come back in because it is on.
To this ball club, a great get in the transfer portal for the defending champs.
Yeah, she's really vital to this team, so doing what she needs to do.
What a women's basketball doubleheader we have for you Thursday night right here on the SEC Network and the ESPN app. Number one, South Carolina, the only undefeated team in Division I, hosts Missouri at 7. And then we'll see the ninth-ranked LSU Tigers once more on the road in Nashville against Vanderbilt. That's coming up Thursday on the SEC Network. Hey, check it out. South Carolina in action tonight. Hey, we'll be curious to see how they go into Thursday's game as they face off against Ole Miss. A tale of 1-2 in the SEC currently.
Right, and so Ole Miss's defense is so solid, and then LSU going to Vanderbilt. Vanderbilt, to me, is a scary, they're just a scary basketball team. Shea Ralph has them playing hard, has got people in key positions, and they play very good offensively, and they're very physical in the defensive end as well.
Layla Reynolds, who made the bucket on that foul from Del Rosario, missing on the free throw. And quickly, then a foul once more. This time it's going against the Gators. And that's going to send LSU to the free throw line. So Erinne Kindred picks up her second personal foul. And we'll see the Tigers at the line.
Florida's playing hard, but they've got to play a little bit. They've got to play smarter. They can't keep putting LSU at the free throw line.
Haley Van Lith is transferred in from Louisville and has been asked to assume a different position. Wanted to play at the next level. You talked about just the guidance that she was seeking from Kim Mulkey from that point guard position.
And her scoring is down, but you're going to see that when she's at the point position. So she's trying to learn, and they're not really relying on her to score as much as she did in the past.
The scoring has been plentiful for the Tigers. They flip it over to Flonjay Johnson, and Johnson on the drive. No, but Morrow put back, rolls off again. Third time is the charm for Morrow and the Tigers.
They are just all over the glass, doing a great job of second chance opportunities, and Florida's got to clean that up.
And hey, Florida's head coach Kelly Ray Finley said, we know that they're better than us on the glass. We've got to be able to match that physicality and be able to bring that grit and toughness, try to hang in there.
It all starts on boxing out, and you got to do it early, and that's just being physical and seeing where the ball's coming off and just box out your player.
Del Rosario comes up with it. Haley Van Lith, 1-on-3. She goes for it. The aggressiveness pays off.
Well, that was a 1-on-3.
Largest lead as they doubled it here in the final minute of this first quarter. Matharu, step back, no. Morrow just wants that rebound, yeah. Sails in to get it. She's got 8 already, correction, 9 in this first quarter alone.
Well, there were 4 LSU people in the paint, players in the paint, and Florida had no one.
Mutharu picks up her second personal foul, so she'll go to the bench with 30.8 seconds left in the quarter.
And Florida's got to be careful with the foul because they don't have a lot of depth, so they've got to clean up the fouling.
With some question, again, how would LSU respond after going on the road and dropping one in Starkville? Thus far, they're answering that with a resounding, we good.
We're okay. Yeah, they obviously they're going to score, but they're holding Florida 11 points right now. And, you know, they've caused them to turn it over. They've caused them to double dribble, to walk. And so those are things that they kind of put Florida in a disadvantage right now.
Zippy Broughton with a big push off, and Kim Mulkey in the crowd wanted it on him.
There's on a Broughton. Lot of officials out here, yeah. Tiffany.
For the ones for today's game, Denise Brooks, Tiffany Bird, and Margaret Timon. No call there, and again, making it difficult. Poked away, Correa comes up with it. The double team, they've got to get a shot off before the end of the quarter, and not able to do so. Shot clock violation, and you hear the roars inside of the Pete Maravich Assembly Center. They like the effort from their LSU Tigers in that opening period.
I've been waiting on this too long. Got a rolling in AP is two tone. Play it safe, I can't move wrong. We was lit the whole night, we was too gone. The first light I had flew on. I'm so up, I might be up on Pluto. No new friends, just a few on. I don't know why they count like I knew on. I just would wait for two. Long. They hate it, they sit it on two. My pockets, they fat, they on two. More. Back then we ain't have it, we having them racks. And they see that the hundreds, I'm dumb, and the money that's coming, they mad about that. See, I'm coming from poverty, you should be proud of me. Y'all people snakes, so I know they surrounding me. Hate to see me when I swerve in the Audi 3. I'm a young prodigy, keep your apologies. We in the building, just throw it up. I'm loving this feeling, just pull it up. When we come through the city, they know it's us. I came in with the gang, so you know it's up. I can't complain, I'm just going up. By my mama, her range is a blood up. I done peeped all the gang, so I know the tug. And I stay in my lane, ain't no tone up. I've been waiting this too long. Got a rolling in AP, it's two tone. Play it safe, I can't move wrong. We was lit the whole night, we was too gone. The first night I had flew on. I'm so up, I might be up on Pluto. No new friends, just a few on. I don't know why they count like I knew on. I just been waiting for two. Long. They hate it, they sit it on two. My pockets, they fat, they on two. More. You miss it, you gotta just move. Look, it just keep getting easy, I swear to God. I keep running through money, I gotta charge. If you start moving funny, I got a dog. Taking pictures, they know me, guess I'm a star. And don't worry about my dog, who we eating. And I only want green, yes, I'm vegan. For my mom, blow it back up in neatness. She'll give me her last if I need it. Yeah, you know, gotta check, cause it's all up. And I know life again, boy, ain't all fair. And I know they gon' slide if I call her. Free my Shayna, she inside the walls, yeah. Free my Shayna, she inside the walls, yeah. She get happy whenever I call her. And I send you to catch me wire. Bustin' down when we all in the mire. I've been waiting on this too long, yeah. Got a rolling in AP, it's two-tone. Play it safe, I can't
from LSU, and I'll tell you, Anissa Morrow has been powering the engine thus far.
Yeah, she's been relentless on the boards. Just finds a way to get position. She scores off the double team for the pass from Reese, and then, you know what? She didn't care if she misses her shot. She just puts it back up for a rebound and a score.
Anissa Morrow, you see the numbers coming into today, close to 18 points in nearly 10 rebounds a game. The double doubles speak for themselves. And again, when you think about just the different dimensions of this LSU team, she just adds another layer of toughness and power and go-get-it-ness to
well,
this group.
Yeah, she just, you get lost when you have Angel Reese and you have Williams and Johnson, you kind of forget about Morrow, and she just steps up, and they just are great at every position on the court.
So you see last year Poa in the game along with Haley Van Lith, and this is a look that we could continue to see a little bit more as the season trends on, because Van Lith, her natural position is off guard. They swing it out, athletically brings it down, keeps it in play, heaves it up, and knocks it down. Long two.
And she's a shooting guard, and she's learning. She's learning the point position, and so, hey, you need a bucket, put her at the off guard. She's going to get it.
Kansas Algis with the ball. The Florida Gators, who had a 6-2 lead earlier in this one, started 3-for-4, but since then, they have gone cold from the field.
Well, those are shots, those wide open penetrate and kick outs. You got to make those.
Last tier, Pola, nice move along the baseline.
Woo.
The other way, Correa with a hand in her face. The triple goes down for Leilani Correa. Remember, coming off a 24-point performance in that win over Texas A&M.
Well, Florida's got to find a way to get her the basketball.
Again, Angel Reese showing off her passing abilities. The assist to Michaela Williams, who puts down the trifecta.
Wow, just clicking on all cylinders.
7 points for Williams. Back the other way and rims around and rolls in for Correa. We talked about just how special she's been in SEC play. Everybody's launching it and everybody's knocking it down.
What?
Nasty head.
Wow. It's a shootout.
These two trading buckets back and forth in the last few possessions. Rimmed off the mark. Van Lith coming up with the board. Reese finds Lith. Morrow with her 10th rebound of the game, and then an offensive foul goes against number 24 in white.
Yeah, I was going to say, guess who get the rebound? It's not hard to imagine Morrow got the rebound and just gets early position, but just got to go straight up.
When you look at this Florida Gator team, they shot the ball pretty well against Texas A&M in their last game, averaging 44% from the floor. What more do they have to do? They've got to be able to knock down shots, as you mentioned, trying to get back here on transition defense.
They've got to get more than one shot. It's one and done on that end, just one and done. They've got to figure out how to get up the boards. And then they've got to do something on the defensive end. LSU's just in a really good rhythm right now.
Hard fall to the floor for both Johnson on the take and Layla Reynolds. And both players being tended to by their teammates to make sure they're okay. Let's get another look at it here. You see Johnson falls first and then trying to come down with the rebound and popping back and hitting the hardwood.
Yeah,
head for Reynolds.
Yeah, and Johnson was just, legs were coming out just as she fell, so I don't think it was anything intentional. It's a hard fall.
Reynolds has that one poked away. Poa nearly got that one. Instead, Rimdahl pulls up from near the SEC logo, no good, and then a collision between her and Haley Van Lith.
And those are the shots that they've got to make. The defense goes flying, and so you're on your own, and you've got to nail that shot in the lane.
Two fouls for Rimdahl, two team fouls apiece for each squad. We think about this LSU team, much different look from what we saw last year, winning the national championship as
That one was a nice feed. In and out for Reese, but relentless on the boards, and she won it more than anybody.
I don't know how she got that. It was a great play, a little pick and roll, bounce it inside, and she missed it, and just got her little rebound stat up.
All right, let's go back to that pick and roll right here.
Really, just slipped the screen and nice pass and just shot it a little too hard, but she's always working. She knew where it was going to come off and put it back in. Yeah, I'm just amazed at how many rebounds she gets. And you know she's going to do it.
Right. Well, just in talking to her throughout the season, you know, one of the things she said, hey, I know my rebounding and defense helps to set the tone. We saw her with a block earlier and already today. The LSU Tigers are shooting the ball exceptionally well. 10 points now for Michaela Williams as LSU is shooting a 58% clip from the floor.
And these are some tough shots, too. Okay, so don't tell me LSU can't play defense. I mean, come on. They're holding Florida to 16 points right now. They can play it when they want to play it. So you'll see, just look at all the help inside, drawing the charge. There's four people in that area in the lane. So LSU, you can do what your coach said is worried about. You can play defense.
Save that one. Vitala Rosario underneath and gets the bucket and one. The 6'6 freshman, Aaliyah Del Rosario, showing off what she can do.
Yeah, she, tough pass, goes up in a crowd and grabs it, gets it blocked one time, doesn't phase her, goes up. And Duke's got it, Duke's big. You got to just make her shoot over you, and Duke cannot put them at the line and just move her hands down. Just make her make a shot over you.
Del Rosario, bright future for her. Played some critical minutes earlier in the season when Angel Reese was out, and then also came up with some good moments in that South Carolina game. And you go back to that game against the top-ranked Gamecocks, snapped a 29-game home win streak. And Kim Mulkey said after the game, hey, it just came down to toughness and experience. As Matharu steals that one, the back out of the night down in transition and finishes it off.
Yeah, and it didn't help that Angel Reese got in foul trouble and was on the bench, their best defender. So. But that's a learning opportunity. Angel Reese has got to stay on the floor.
Last tier Poa. Here's Matharu back the other way. Too strong. Reese skies to get the board.
Yeah, just Florida's one and done. They've got to come around. They've got to go to the boards.
Slowing down the pace a little bit. Everyone taking a breath after a frantic back and forth.
Nice.
And a fearlessness that we've seen out of Leah Matharu. And boy, they're happy to have her back into the lineup. Her last game was back on January 22nd. But, you know, when you've got Matharu on the floor, she's a guaranteed double-digit scorer. She's within two of that. The eyes, the assists, and Del Rosario finishing it off. They swing it around. Kinzasaugus asking for it instead. Matharu directing traffic up top.
And that's
sizing up Van Lith. Foul on the floor. It goes against the Gators. We'll step aside with 3:26 remaining in the first half.
Tommy John is for men who...
I got bris on the beat, he go crazy.
What you working with? Yeah. What you working with? What you working with? What you working with?
Pay for this.
Yeah.
Get your bands up. Oh, you ain't tricking? I'ma hit your mans up. Cold. I keep fire in the summertime. He gon' keep the bills paid, cause he know a it's always in my business. JC, what you really do? I be at home playing fetch by a swimming pool. I'm a real big dog. What Scrappy do? Doing all that wifey knowing he don't feel with you. Post a girl in your dreams. I'ma hold it, bust whoever in between. Gangsta, JT, Medellin. Haven't heard from the ops yet. They ain't said a thing.
22 comments in the chat already. Let me see what y'all said. Defense looking amazing. Yes. LSU wants this more. I can't play sideways because I can't find the clean version on YouTube. I don't like all the cussing on the YouTube page. This game fire. They feeling it. Let's go. Four needs to come back. Yes, 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 yes. Hard to learn the point in 1 year. They are balling today. I like the rotating player. Gets them all breathers. Exactly. The second pick is foul. I like Angel in it, but yeah, you know how they do. Let me see. I'm so impressed. Don't forget to like. Yes, definitely like the stream. And we're back.
Warlick, Tiffany Green, and if you're Kelly Ray Friendly and you're in the huddle, take us inside. And what are you saying to your team?
Yeah, Steph's spot on. You got to settle down. You got to be a little bit more deliberate. Move the ball side to side. Make LSU defend. LSU's having to defend maybe one or two passes, and the ball's going up. And I'm not really. I've said a lot about Florida's rebounding. I'm not sure everybody else knows when the shot is going up. So this be a little bit more deliberate. Settle in, settle down, try to figure out how we're going to get a good
lead. Also, guys, let me know if the internet seems a little better with the lag, because over the weekend we got fiber internet, which is supposed to be faster upload speed, so help with streaming. Let me know if it seems a bit better.
Settle down for the final 3:26 of this half. Try to come up with some stops and get into rhythm offensively.
And Florida can make an easy run by getting their defense to spark their offense and get some transition buckets.
That shot off the mark. Correa coming back up the court. When you have Correa and Matharu on the court, this can be a dangerous duo, but instead, another turnover for the Gators. They've got 13 now in the process. Matharu picks up her third personal foul.
It just feels like Florida is dribbling into trouble. Just trying to create. Again, moving the ball side to side. And they're a little frustrated right now. They're fouling. Officials calling foul. They may not think it's a foul, but it's called. They got to handle it. But
yeah, G3 calls that out all the time, how we like play lower when we play lower teams. So I agree with this, and
last
I know
year,
G3
Poa
does too.
At the stripe, as the Tigers lead the nation in free throws made per game at just under 21, along with attempts better than 28 a game.
Well, they're on track right now,
yeah,
to possibly beat that mark.
To be brought off the glass, no good. Morrow feels like she just wants every rebound.
She just had to get it because Morrow was there.
Spin move by last tier, Paula.
Wow.
And it gets the fans to their feet.
Woo.
The home Tigers have their largest lead of the game. Salgas for three, yes! Much needed there again to see the ball go through the hoop if you're the Gators.
Nice, nice screen down, created a wide open shot and nailed it.
Good defense on the other end by Kindred. So coming up with a stop and a chance to cut this deficit even more. Salgas going again, this time a little bit deeper.
got to get on the weak side boards right there.
And lift in the middle. Let's it go. Balance jumper, yes. And Haley Van Lith has found her offense today. She's gotten it going. She is leading the Tigers this afternoon. She's got 11 points.
Well, I think Van Lith was a little surprised she was this open. Yeah. Well, LSU's shooting right now 61%. So, but they're doing a great job of distributing the basketball and moving, attacking the basket, kicking, attacking the basket, shooting, scoring in the lane.
Leilani Correa at the free throw line. She's got 5 points this afternoon. Tuesday night, we'll have a men's basketball doubleheader right here on the SEC Network and the ESPN app, featuring the second game at 8:30 Eastern. Antonio Reeves and number 10 Kentucky taking on Vanderbilt at historic Memorial Gymnasium in Nashville. As the Wildcats look to bounce back after that loss to fifth-ranked Tennessee yesterday. On the inbound, Salgas, and so the final 1:38 here for Florida. What do you want to see if you're Coach Finley?
Well, got a good stop down here on the defensive end. Get a good look here. Just chip away. Needed to have that opportunity to score.
They turned it over, but they get it right back. Jariah Warren coming up with the steal. Faith Duke being guarded by Reese. Doesn't necessarily look for a shot. Oh, great slip. Oh, fine to the basket on the back door.
Yeah, that's just reading your defense. That's needs to ignite Florida.
Here's Reese looking. She's got range, showing it off from the free throw line. She said, hey, look, I can step back and shoot if I just feel like I need to or I have more confidence to. And she's shown that she can at times this season.
I don't know what else to do. I mean, you got to guard for the penetration. But when Angel Reese can make those shots, she's a difficult guard.
And they want more of that from Correa on the other end now with 10 points. The pull-up J is true. Well, LSU came out in this second quarter after putting up 24 in the first. They put up 28 here. And 4.5 seconds remaining in the quarter. They could add to that total at the free throw line.
Yeah, the more I watch Angel Reese, I'm amazed of how she catches the ball in traffic. I mean, there were two Florida Gators around her, and she caught it, was able to throw the ball up and draw a foul. When I'm Florida, just go straight up and take your chances that she's going to make the shot.
Reese knocks down both. As Angelica Velez comes to the ball game, 4.5 seconds remaining in the first half. What an excellent start it's been for LSU. Zippy Broughton trying to get a shot up before the end of the half, and no good.
Hey, Velez got in before half? What? Yes. Y'all said y'all saw Kent too. Poa playing a beautiful game. Whoa, I know. I was like, whoa. Ooh. That really be irritating me. Kim been seeing the comments, put in Izzy. Guys, I'm going to try to get an interview with somebody to see if they would come on and talk to us in the chat. One of the players. Why the sub with 5 seconds? Girl, Put Izzy in is crazy. Put her in. Everybody really in their bag for real. Hello, fellow naggers. I had a page idea for comment coach or coach, something like that. Okay, so does anybody know anything else about Flajay? I did see her go down, and I don't remember seeing her get back in. People have been asking, is Flajay okay? We saw her get up and walk. Any update on Flajay? Flajay, cool, she would do it. Yeah. Probably a little shaken up. Okay. It's precautionary, it looks like. Do you think it's worth it to put it back in? Won't know until after halftime. I hope she's okay. She's on the bench, so she could be good. Coach just wanted to run the bench. That's good. Okay. Sounds good. All right. Well, it's halftime. Does anybody want to come up and speak? What should we do during halftime right now? My daughter wants to wear her interview POA. I know, but I feel like they'll probably want to wait. I feel like they'll probably want to wait till after the season. Because y'all know y'all be asking. They'll probably give us a list of what we can ask about. So why is Pool not with us with no more? You know, my daughter wants to wear her swimming vest around the house. She wants to go swimming. Okay, baby, go play under your bed. Go swimming. Thanks for the shout out, Slime. Of course, Floss Clutch. If Belt's a... Great, great game. I know, media trained. I know. Yes, I would love to see her. I had got Anissa email. I was going to reach out to her, too. I saw her just do a interview with Vision Valley. They're another, like, independent media team. Company. Next year, we're going to do things much better. Like, I'm not that far away from Baton Rouge. I would love for on the big games for us to be able to go there and do like the post game press conference. You can get a media pass and things like that. And then have somebody run the lives and do the comments. You know, we're working together. Somebody who had made us those edits was from our TikTok. So I'm just going to keep working with people. Ole Miss on South Carolina. Let me watch this. Y'all been saying that. Let me see. Let me go to this real quick. Flajay got two fouls too. Okay. Okay, Ole Miss versus number one South Carolina. We could have took them down. I couldn't even speak after that game for real, guys, because we literally could have took them down. And when I went back to see, like, what happened in those last few minutes, it was literally just somebody coming off from guarding Breezy Hall to ball watch
put Marquisha Davis at the top. And when Cardoso was in the game, to go to her side off those ball screens. Cardoso subbed out for
kicks. Me too. They be having me crying, guys.
Tessa Johnson corrals it for the Gamecocks. Seconds to go in the half. Been an interesting first half. Close the entire way.
Now Tessa Johnson playing a four for South Carolina.
Marquisha Davis with the defense and then scooping the rebound.
They at home too? Oh, we would love to be upset at home for them.
Collins flying through the lane, but misses.
Right. We rooting for Ole Miss today.
1 minute to go. South Carolina just won for its last eight.
Look at that.
And that's a foul on Pow Pow. Whistled against Snuda Collins. Her second.
Like, that's a big possession for South Carolina. They needed to get something out of that if she hits these free throws, because a couple more possessions
for Ole Miss, they could head into the locker room with some momentum. They've had great confidence. They've kept it close in this first half.
Well, South Carolina is second in the nation in field goal percentage. They usually shoot 51% from the field, but today just 39%.
Coach will be able to go in the locker room and go, look, we did what we were supposed to do defensively. Now they've got to find where they can convert on the offensive end.
8 seconds here. Raven the kick out to Tessa Johnson in the corner. The first three of the afternoon.
Okay. Yeah, we'll see. Anyways, it is halftime for us. Is everybody following our TikTok? Is everybody following our TikTok? I just turned it off. Like literally.
But two people that I like have.
What you touching now, Chosen? What's the TikTok? This is our TikTok, guys. Follow us on TikTok. Your phone needs to get on the charger. Here. You want to say hi to the chat? Okay. Say hi.
Hi.
Say hi.
And you sit on the chair.
Okay. My baby said hi, guys. But yeah, this is our TikTok. Make sure you guys subscribe on there. Quiet, boo. We're about to go back to the game. It's only 15 minutes. I'm going to play some music. And we'll be back.
Damn, like damn, heck? Like damn, like little done? Dummy got cold as Knox. What? Boom, spin through his block. Got a bus, so it's gonna be a late hit. We ain't duck a little, we right here. We ain't cuffing, we giving them the pipe hit. Don't do no crying, we told you we fight here. Smoking on what, we gon' bend through his block. Little dummy got cold with his knock. Little dummy get put in a box. Be talking, but be pop.
Big four, man, the biggest four. I had to get on here, talk to the people.
Tell me all this shit, yeah, you know I made another one.
Made another one. Speaking from the heart, that's all I could do. Yeah, the album right now.
Say I don't need time, but time is all I got. I wanna be fine, but fine is what I'm not. You want me to read minds, and I don't see the thought. I gotta feed mine, so I've been on the clock. Like lately, I feel like I'm mine, been in two different places. We've been running out of time, running two different races. I just ran between the line, we on two different pages. I've been ignoring all the signs because it's
easy. 10 points, all Lady Tiger. Second half coming up after break.
Feel amazing, days done changed, now I'm all dripped out in Dior. You say this all that you can give, well I need more. You say you always by my side, I gotta leave yours. Cause I got things I wanna do, I gotta see more. You know I love you, but I gotta do what's best for me. Man, I'm the greatest and they not expecting less from me. I gave you all my tears, I swear you took the best of me. And I'll be damned if I let you take the rest of me. Haters who act like friends, they the worst enemies. Watch who I'm giving good news to, cause they envy me. And when they talk behind my back, are you defending me? Probably not, but the same person that depend on me. Seem as I'm growing every day.
day, man, that's how cold it get. I wish my granddad would call me cause he older. And if I lost you and we ain't talking, man, my soul will split. I gotta cherish what I got, can't get no more of this. Lord knows, it's a crazy world. I got my head on straight, so it ain't blazing her. They made me get up and grind, they made you lazier. To my father, they'll never take his baby girl. And I'm like, Lord knows, it's a crazy world. Got my head on straight, so it ain't phasing her. They made me get up and grind, they made you lazier. They took my father, they'll never take his baby girl. And I say, I don't need time, but time is all I got. I wanna be fine, but fine is what I'm not. You want me to read minds, and I don't see the thought. I gotta feed mine, so I've been on the clock. Like, lately, I feel like our mind been in two different places. We've been running out of time, running two different races. I just read between the lines, we on two different pages. I've been ignoring all the signs because it feel amazing.
Those shots, those wide open, penetrating, kick out. You gotta make those.
Last tier, Pola, nice move along the baseline from the field.
Big four, man, the biggest four. I had to get on here, talk to the people.
Tell me all this shit.
For you. Early in the morning, late at night, it don't even matter what time it is.
I will wait for you.
President Roller, RM, wait. Whenever I found time, it's okay.
ATL,
Jacob, ATL, Jacob. You pray for my demons, girl, I got you. Every time I sip on, I get vulnerable. Annoying the sounds of the storm when it comes. She understand I can't take her everywhere I'm going. I've been in the field like the children of the corn. I can hear your tears when they drop over the phone. Get mad at yourself cause you can't leave me alone. Gossip and messy, that ain't what we doing. Traveling around the world, over the phone dropping tears. I get more vulnerable when I do this. When you drunk you tell me exactly how you feel. When I'm loaded, I keep it real. Need to tell a real one exactly what it is.
Yes, hello there. Poa is having her a game. She is shooting. She's playing defense. She's running the point while HBL's on the shooting guard. And they are looking great out there. The whole team is looking real good. Yes, Poa is looking good. So you guys like that? It's coming real soon. Yeah, do you have any update on new music for from Flash A for us? Are we going to hear anything with Rod Waving her? I know she opened for him on tour. I would love that. Yes, hit the likes, hit the likes, hit the likes. And I'm going to feel like Michaela deserves it too. We're going to have to see what happens. Some Polo G songs. I love Polo G. What songs from him? I'm not sure anything recent. I liked his old stuff. Like A Boogie old stuff too. Okay, I think we are back.
New women's basketball. You go back to the 1970s to the 2020s. Wearing the purple and gold is something of pride and honor for these individuals on the court who helped to build this program. And
right,
boy, he's got a pulse again under head coach
team.
Kim Mulkey.
Play
Holly Warlick, Tiffany Green here with you. And if you look at that first half, LSU was completely dominant.
Well, everybody contributed, Tiffany. They scored well from the free throw line. They scored well from the three-point line. And it was all about everybody getting into the action. And they stepped up, they got rebounds, they hit threes, they got to the free throw line, and it was a team effort.
Hey,
you look at these highlights, they didn't talk about how well their defense
is the day number nine.
We think about
LSU
the stars among them for LSU. They are outscoring the Florida Gators all by themselves.
Go Tiger Hoops has become
Haley
the number
has come
one
alive.
LSU wide stream location,
Reese, along with
and that is
Michaela Williams, but Anissa Moore, who has
support.
Done excellent
Seriously,
work on the board. This is the type
is,
of LSU
of
dominance that we've seen before and that many are hopeful
now,
will carry over into next
yeah,
month.
If you're loving the
I don't
vibe,
think
want to help us keep the Gold
shot.
Tiger Hoops train rolling, consider
and
throwing
good
a little
looks,
love
moved
on
the ball,
Cash App our
they
way.
They've gone side
that's
to side. Everybody,
Cash
again,
Gold
got into
Tiger
the action. But
your support is
Coach Mulkey's going to be excited about their defensive effort.
Shooting better than 62% from the floor and 3 for 5 from three-point range, so that's 60% as well. We'll see what Florida's defense can do to try to slow down this Tiger attack, and that's one way to do it is see a turnover, Cole, back into the hands of the Gators. And what type of adjustments do you make?
Well, just right there, I love that the Florida jumped out into a zone. They weren't able to handle LSU in man-to-man, so they jumped out of zone, got a turnover here. So a good basket, a quick basket, and just like that, and moved the ball, had a solid shot. Good look.
We heard Steffi talk about it earlier, and then you mentioned as well the shot selection for the Florida Gators, and that's certainly a shot that they would want from Zippy. Brought back the other way is Angel Reese bodying big and getting up in. 13 points for Reese.
Florida does not need to – don't look it up at the clock. Don't look at the score.
It's just play ball just like that. Duke to Warren, and that was great offensive execution for the Gators.
Just got to chip away, and you got to find some way to get a stop against LSU because they're red hot on the offensive end.
Longe Johnson sees that one roll off the rim. Florida, that got numbers. Rimdahl decides to keep it, and Broughton tried to save it, but not in time.
Well, probably got away with a little walk there, and yeah, it's a physical game. Basketball is a physical game. Just a little knockdown right there.
Yeah. Among the keys for Florida to try to contend with the defending national champions, they needed that grit and toughness to handle that physicality as Michaela Williams on the take to the bucket. Boy, I tell you, Williams is just one of those players who is special now and for years to come.
Well, she's just a difficult guard because she shoots a three and then she can drive. And then you see Duke stepping out and hit the three. Okay, she didn't want to go in to battle Angel Reese, so she just steps out and says, all right, I'll hit a three.
First points of the game. Williams pull up. Jay is true. The mid-range is just one of the many tools that she has in her toolbox. Duke going for it, getting on the floor. Snatched away by Van Lith. Johnson was just quick. Punches it out to Van Lith, off the mark, into the hands of Zippy Broughton, who finds the true freshman, Layla Reynolds, streaking down, hard foul by Williams, and Reynolds will shoot a couple.
Yeah, I like that Florida, they get a stop, rebound, and run, and so it takes away all the help that LSU's been bringing, and that was just a one-on-one, and Reynolds just attacked the basket and drew the foul.
Reynolds, lone freshman on the team who was quickly inserted into the lineup, a McDonald's All-American. He's out of PG County, Maryland. And when we've watched Reynolds this season, we've seen some flashes of her potential to be really good, but you come to the college game, you adjust, and then you move into SEC play. That's another type of adjustment as well.
Well, it gets faster and it gets more physical, and coming out of high school, those are two things you've got to really adapt to, and the game is so up and down, and you got to be in great shape, and then you got to take the hit and take the contact.
Flexen Morrow, 9 points.
I believe I'd be flexing if I was in Morrow's body.
Reynolds tucks, and Reese comes up with steal.
See, that's what she'll learn when she gets older. You attack, you got to kick it out earlier.
And right now, LSU just showing off just the assertiveness, the aggressiveness, the athleticism, and physicality, as we mentioned.
Yeah, Florida's just got to find a way to just tame, really, LSU.
But that's a great example of what you've seen Kelly Ray Finley do in her third season as head coach, pulling players aside. Many of them love playing for her because they say, hey, look, she's motivating me, she's encouraging me, and she's maybe chastising me in the process, yeah, but in a loving way.
Well,
you know?
She's teaching the game, and you can teach the game during a game. It doesn't always have to be in practice. And And as it's hard at times, you're encouraging, but then you gotta correct the things that they need to be corrected.
Jariah Warren picks up her first personal foul. So Haley Van Lith will shoot a couple from the charity stripe. And is able to knock down the first. Quick reminder, Monday night, SEC Insight grants you an all-access pass to LSU women's basketball at 9 Eastern, then go all-access with the Florida men's program. You'll get behind-the-scenes footage and hear from the players and coaches right here on the SEC Network and the ESPN app.
I like those. You get to see an inside look at the team, the coach. Mm-hmm.
And you get to learn them a little bit more. You know, obviously, we're watching game day. We're calling the games, but all of the little details and nuances that go on in between is what we get a chance to see. When you think about this LSU team, the way they were able to get some rest, took a couple of days off, experienced a bye week, and now back in action again. And looks like midseason form, kind of what we saw a lot of in non-conference from LSU right here. When you think about just how they project forward and you think about the SEC tournament and postseason play, this is a group you don't want to match up against them, whoever you are.
they learned from their two losses, and look, they're clicking on all cylinders here, and we said earlier that in the bracketology, they're seeded fourth. If I'm a number one seed, I don't want to play them. There's no way they're a four seed. It's just no way.
You think about, you know, being shocked by Auburn in this SEC play, snap that 16-game winning streak, and then you go South Carolina, top-ranked team, and then you think Mississippi State. Those are the three losses within conference play of the four overall. But do you find that can be a good thing?
Oh, I do. I think it's great. It brings out some of your weaknesses. Sometimes the coach can tell you you're not doing something, and if you keep winning, you're like, yeah, right, okay, well, we're winning. But it'll catch up to you. And a lot of things caught up to them those games. The defensive end, getting in too much foul, fouling out. Those things really add up, and they can cause you to lose. And so you zero in on why you lost the game.
Well, Kim Mulkey's group with a comfortable lead here with just over 5 minutes to go in this third quarter. And thus far, they have answered any questions about how they would respond after those back-to-back losses. Aaliyah Matharu at the free throw line for the Florida Gators. 9 points for Matharu, who had missed the last couple of games. She's back into action, and she's got double digits now.
And Florida just happened to fall into the game that after LSU lost two in a row.
And you know, if you're the Florida Gators, that you're going to try to, you're going to receive an angry LSU group, a very determined Tiger team.
And for that reason, you got to play flawless.
And a blocking foul goes against last tier Poa. And we're going to step aside with 4:49 remaining in this third quarter. LSU up big.
Are you serious about what? Are we still up on YouTube? Blocking foul, game over. Okay. Coach not listening to us. Hopefully the bench gets to play soon. Chosen, stop being dramatic.
gang if you let you fly. Ain't bad if you got a ride. Big guns and a lot of zip ties. Does she look like me? Quit lying.
Don't stop
the beat.
Don't stop.
Don't stop
the beat.
Don't stop.
Don't stop the beat.
We gon' spin and kill.
Everybody.
And we're telling all.
Gunter, well, they made the official honor, and how special it was for many of her former players to be back on the court as the late, great Sue Gunter was recognized. And wow, what a phenomenal coach she was, a torchbearer, a pioneer, two-time SEC champion, basketball Hall of Fame coach who coached some of the greats better than two decades here and helped lead the Tigers to their first Final Four appearance with some of those great players she coached.
She just brings a big smile on my face. I had the opportunity to be coached by Sue in the 1980 Olympics. She was a great recruiter, great teacher, just a great person. Tiffany, she made everybody she met feel super special.
When you think about Sylvia Fowles and Simone Augustus, Marie Ferdinand Harris, I mean, just some of those great names within women's college basketball. Impressive indeed, but Gunter sees the program from up above in great hands with another Hall of Fame coach, and Kim Mulkey, who surpassed her career wins earlier this season.
And Sue helped get the ball rolling here, and Kim's done a great job to pick it back up. And what a test to have over 100 alumni come back and honor Sue and honor the opportunity to have her name on the court.
And in talking with Kim, you know, she just mentioned the importance of being able to stand on their shoulders, to recognize those players, to reach out to them, to let them know that you helped build this program and you're special and you matter and we want you around. She said she gave a piece of the hardwood from that national championship season last year to the alumni, to the players. And that is something that they can take with them and know that they had a hand in the first ever national championship for the women's basketball program.
Yeah, and Tiffany, it speaks a lot for them coming back. A lot of times the alumni don't come back. You got to come back. You got to be honored. You got to understand you helped build this program, but then you've got to turn around and support it as well.
Back the other way to answer is Aaliyah Matharu for the Florida Gators. She's got a dozen points now. And if you're thinking about the Tiger alumni, well, they have to love what they've seen in the show that's been put on thus far by this 2024 version of the LSU Tigers.
And Florida did a good job of, they're in their zone, got a good stop, and they just need to convert on those opportunities.
Kayla Williams into traffic, able to somehow kick that out, swings it around. Flauge Johnson for three, yes! Standing in place, looking it down.
Wow. Yeah, Angel Reese didn't get a loose ball, didn't have anywhere to go. Give it to Big Flo.
Yeah. Flauge Flossum real quick. Super talented guard, just a sophomore out of Savannah, Georgia. Correa on the inbound.
Ooh, she sure did.
Traveling violation against Matharu. It's just been a tough afternoon for Kelly Ray Finley's crew here on the road in the Pete Maravich Assembly Center. You think about just this atmosphere and what it's been like throughout, you know, I think the snowball kind of from last season and then how it's picked up in intensity this year. The crowds that have come out and witnessed this group trying to defend their title.
Well, this atmosphere is what women's basketball should be like everywhere. And they came out to support, obviously coming off a national championship. But, you know, you want to support a winner. You get a little taste of that. And then it's what Kemp, now the expectation is out of the roof. And so today they've played almost a flawless game. So the crowd, you would think they're up by this much people. There's not a person that's left this building.
Williams inside to the 6'6 freshman. Del Rosario has it bounce off the hoop.
What a great look.
Reynolds pull up chain. Transition is true. In the process, she lost her shoe. I wasn't trying to rhyme right there, but just kind of happened. Reynolds.
Angel Reese is assisting her.
Correa. Johnson tried to poke the ball away from behind, picks up the personal foul. Del Rosario lost that shoe there. She was trying to put it on. Let me get back. No, it's gone again.
Kicked it off.
Rimdahl stops, pops, it drops.
Nice. Nice hesitation and patience.
Angel Reese bringing it up the court. 6'3 junior.
I'm not sure I want Angel as my point guard, but.
Hey, you know, she's just showing off the skill set, that's all. No continuation there. You know how she can bang her on the board.
Yeah.
She is tough inside. She's a walking double-double. And she gives you all of the attitude and toughness that you want in the
Absolutely.
Process.
You want somebody that has that drive, that spunk. That's just how she plays. You got to love it. I mean, double-doubles, and I always say rebounding is just heart and effort. And it takes a lot of energy. And let me tell you, she's a rebounding machine.
And a star in our women's game and breakthrough athlete of the year. The ESPYs record-setting season just speaks to the all-around nature of Angel Reese and the inspiration that she's been for so many.
There you go, Florida. Florida did a great job of keeping LSU off the boards, and they need to build on that.
We talked about Leilani Correa, who inbounded the ball, who comes off the bench leading all scorers in SEC play with better than 25 points. She scored all 10 points in this game in the second quarter, and that shot is blocked by Anissa Morrow coming over to help in time.
Yeah, I like her. I like the look, though. That's the look that Florida is wanting and got.
And Morrow wanted that one on Correa. And the offensive foul goes against.
Yeah, I don't know about
the senior.
Yeah, I'm not sure about that. I. I don't know. Did she extend it?
Extend that forearm. That's what they
saw there in the offensive foul on that. Yeah, she extended him push off.
Yeah. No. We saw it in slow-mo. Yeah. I don't
We can say this. We already know that SEC basketball is physical, but here is exceptionally physical. Yeah. Today is Van Lift.
Man, we were talking earlier. I think the officials have done a great job this season of letting teams play because it is physical and doing a good job of just controlling the atmosphere, the tempo, just, you know, and I'm a former coach saying that. It's hard to come out. I'm usually trying to help them out, but it is physical, and you've got to play through it. And as you said, SEC it's always been, that's mm-hmm. their MO. It is a physical conference and athletic. A lot of teams don't like it. They get it when SEC teams play other conferences. They're like, you know, it's too physical. Well, it's how they play.
Van Lith, hailing from the state of Washington here, and the boot now, and she's got 19 points. But I think that season high of 6 rebounds is something that is going to please her coach as. Poa and Duke tied up. A little tempers flare.
Oh, wait a minute.
Didn't take kindly to Poa trying to snatch it away. Both players trying to fight for the basketball, playing hard.
Just a little frustrated. Just a little frustration there.
Where the replay?
You know what? I like it. I like it. I like her being.
Wait a minute.
No, I don't know what happened, but
let me see. Here we go.
See, Dude has it, and then Poa tries to come from behind and rip it away, and kind of slings her around in the process. But the temperature is rising here in the PMAC.
She didn't like being slung.
No.
All right.
Family from Sudan, grew up in. Vancouver, Canada. Faith Duke, she takes a seat. Correa with the ball in her hands. Closing seconds. And an offensive foul against Erin Kendrick. And that is her fifth foul. So she is done for the afternoon.
Well, when you set your screen, you've got to get set. And it's up to the offensive player with the ball to run your defense into that screen. And just a tough call.
Van Lith puts it up before the end of the quarter. The exclamation point there for the Tigers. 78-43, make it now 80-43 after that. Van Lith.
Yeah, she's gonna take it. She's not throwing it. She looks up in this crowd. It's like, what do you expect?
I am loving it.
Thanks everyone, especially Vicky. She saved us enough to help us open our second location.
I don't want her.
Mulkey says she got this. She got HBO for a reason. HBO, put up them numbers. I love it.
Cause I'm all white, man. Cause I'm all white, man. Mr. White, now you heard me bust a million. Cause I'm all white. This would be the remix. Cause I'm all white. Savage Life. Bust a million. Man, you already know what it is. You heard me? We still on. We still riding on chrome. We still pulling up. White, man. Look, hey, I pull up at the club. VIP gas tank on. But all drinks on me, wipe it out. Fresh kicks, fresh white, tall tee, fresh NFL hat, fresh bows with the grease, wipe it out. Wanna hit me with the heat, real recognized, real
chicken lady. I've been rolling about a week. You can tell I got cake by the diamonds in my tooth. White, black shade, so you know when rolling. They ain't check me at the door, so ain't no telling what I'm holding. White, bad, they gon' bust it wide open. Flashing in the gray, but I'm in they approaching. White, small, tall figures, y'all crawl. We gon' get and dog. White, y'all call, put my all killer, get your issue, and whoever fall with. Cause I'm all white, 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 cause I'm all white.
Colonial Life Arena. No ticket could be found for today's game. Kim Mulkey said, hey, I wanted to see improvement from our defense. We had to focus on us during that bye week. And when you look over the last two games, which South Carolina was a part of, that opponent's point per game to today, a drastic improvement.
Yeah, and so I think she made her point. And stats don't lie. So they have 43 today. She was given up entirely. Kim knows you can't give up over 76 points and expect to win a basketball game unless you're just shooting a very, very high percentage shot. So, nice.
Great percentage from the floor. Better than 55% throughout the game for LSU. And again, Angel Reese doing her job in every angle. Six assists now for the All-American.
She's just showing that she's such a complete player right now, can do just a little bit of everything.
She's up the floor, Flauge Johnson with a nice up and under. Well, Flauge Johnson is just an exciting player to watch, and you just never know what's gonna happen with the ball in her hands. Back to Correa, looks to Duke. Trying to help her create as Correa nice. Goes inside, and what a take by Leilani Correa.
Ooh, she challenged Reese right there. Nice drive in Florida. Hey, get it to your horse right there. And she goes, and look, there's really four people around her, and finishes and gets an and one.
What a spectacular move by Leilani Correa. Remember, she had three consecutive 30-point games. Folks in SEC play, dropped 30 against Georgia, 31 against Mississippi State, and then had a career high against Ole Miss. That's how she's leading all scorers in SEC play. It's tailed off from that here today, but got 13 points and leading the way for the Gators.
Well, every point she's had today has been difficult. She's had to create her own shot, make some tough shots. LSU's done a really good job on her, but hey, she continues to.
Anissa Morrow, that's a part of her game too. Yeah, I can do that. Yeah. 10th three of the ball, 10th three of the season rather for Anissa Morrow. Michaela Williams sprinting down the floor, pull up jumper, no.
Great opportunity for Florida to go and attack the basket.
That's exactly what Aliyah Matharu did. Draws the foul on Michaela Williams.
And see, Damar, she's just waiting it, looking back in the defender off, and I'd be smiling too if I shot the ball like that.
Junior out of Chicago, played at hometown DePaul before coming over. National Freshman of the Year back in 2022. And again, Morrow has just been outstanding. 14th double-double of the season for Anissa Morrow. 67th of her career with her 12 and 16 today.
Florida again, just trying to change it up a little bit, get something out of their defense, running a zone. They just got to make sure that they close out on the three-point shooters and box out.
Tracking down her own shot is Haley Van Lith with a long rebound, and then afterward, a foul goes against the Florida Gators. Jariah Warren, the guilty party.
Oh, you can't just can't do you can't do that.
Morrow, that one was altered by Reynolds, but she got a piece of Morrow in the process. Second personal foul for Reynolds. Second for the Gators. What a women's basketball doubleheader we have for you Thursday night right here on the SEC Network and the ESPN app. Top-ranked South Carolina hosting Missouri at 7 Eastern, followed by LSU on the road at Memorial Gymnasium in Nashville at 9. Should be a great night of hoops indeed. Well, halfway through the SEC season, this back half is going to pick up all the more as the push for the postseason. Right now, your top four teams in conference: South Carolina, Ole Miss currently in action, Tennessee along with LSU.
And it's shaping out to who you thought would be at the top. And then there's a bunch of teams right there in the middle. So it's it will make the SEC tournament really interesting.
It'll take place in Greenville, South Carolina, Bon Secours Arena. And taking a look at Charlie Cream's bracketology, the latest SEC projections have, no shock there, South Carolina, the number one projected seed, but yeah, also LSU, number four, surprised at that.
If I'm a number one seed, I don't want LSU in my bracket. I think they're a lot higher than a number four. If not one, they've got to be a two. Just, they played South Carolina so solid, and they have. And the reason why the four is because they lost some teams they, quote unquote, shouldn't have lost to.
What do you think about Florida as a spill of players underneath the basket? Four go down.
It looked like a boat, like pins in a boat.
It did.
Oh, goodness.
Going through, and then boom, all going for the ball, and then they all fall down.
Almost a strike.
Yeah.
There was one left.
That 10 pin was left standing.
Wow.
Well, Florida is on the bubble currently in that bracketology, and a number of teams within the SEC and the last four in, last four out, next four.
Yeah, and Arkansas is on the bubble. I've done a lot of Arkansas games, and they're a dangerous team because they shoot the three ball well, and they've got speed. Sailor Poffenbarger is just you talk about a rebounding machine. Whew, it's hard to keep her off the boards.
One of the best in the country as it relates to defensive rebounds. And Anissa Morrow with her second triple of the game. Morrow is feeling it along with the Tigers as they're shooting still better than 54% in this game.
I don't even think she looked at the rim. Goodness. Yeah, they find her and look. Well, she had a time to shape up and get her feet set, and goodness, she's having a heck of a day.
And she's been a player that's just been fun to watch. And when you think about her game, yes, still a junior, but the way it can translate if she wants to go to the next level in the WNBA, she's got all of the tools in her tool bag.
She shoots the three. She's aggressive. She attacks the basket. And here's what I love. Tiffany, she has 16 rebounds today. Just attacking the basket, getting in. And we're in the pros. You got to stand out and do something different. And I like she can get up down the floor. And she's a tough player to defend. And you got to keep her off the boards.
I think back to that game against Virginia in the non-conference. She had 16 boards to go along with a season-high 37 points. And they've just been able to rely on her. She's just been steady throughout. She can carry you if you need to. She can play compliment wherever she is needed. She has just been a nice piece to fit in.
You almost forget about her because then you're worried about Angel Reese inside, and then you have Flaugenay out, and Williams, and you almost forget. I mean, who are you gonna put your weaker defender on? And that's hard to do with this LSU team.
The Fab Five of starters for LSU with Michaela Williams, Anissa Morrow, who makes the bucket there, along with Angel Reese, Haley Van Lith, and Flaugenay Johnson.
Great pass, just unselfish. Williams could have probably taken it herself, and just great pass inside.
A hard drive to the hoop from Jariah Warren. Next 2 points. Morrow off balance there, running in to get that one. And then the collision, the putback by Jermaine Kent, the true freshman out of Oak Forest, Illinois, as Poa, Kent, Williams, Del Rosario on the floor. A couple of freshmen in Kenton Del Rosario, who comes up with the rebound along with Williams. Tried to force it in there tomorrow. Jariah Warren was right there as well. Warren, who has been a solid rebounder and contributor for this Florida Gator team, and she's back to her home state of the boot out of Lake Charles, Louisiana.
It's always fun to come home, and when they usually when they announced Florida, players are booing, but when they announced her, she had a great round of applause.
Fouled from behind is Reynolds, as Anissa Morrow collects her third personal foul.
Yeah, the game's probably out of reach for Florida, but they're still playing hard, and I love that they get the ball in and they're attacking. And that's what they've got to build on, is attacking the basket, getting LSU in transition defense.
And it's one of the things when you think about Kelly Ray Finley, just having covered her over the years, very grateful for the way she says her team works, and she talks a lot about Gator gratitude and says, hey, it's like a muscle. If you don't work it, you're gonna lose it. You know, you gotta use it and keep getting stronger and stronger. And these are the type of moments where you as a team are gonna get stronger. You're gonna learn. You understand that you're coming into the home of the defending national champions. They're ticked off because they lost their last two. You know you're gonna get their best shot.
Yeah,
and yet they're still out here competing.
They're mad, and if you look at it, Florida is undersized just the height-wise, but that's the stuff that they're going to build from. They will learn from this and go back, and you know they got to get the thing about the SEC is just like at LSU. You got to go back and go back to work because you got another game coming up.
That three wiped off the board for Michaela Williams as an offensive foul called against LSU. And I think they're going to review that one as Denise Brooks goes to the scores table. Let's take another look at it here.
Yeah, I don't think they'll count it because it happened before the shot.
Last year, Poa just runs into the Florida Gator defender. We'll take a look at it. We'll talk about it, and we'll come back to the decision on the other side.
Winter sports more than sports. When your highlight reel opens the door to 4 years of higher education, zero student loan debt, and
Yeah, biggest phone, yeah. Big four flogger.
Look, and they say big four was you scared to make diamonds up out of pressure. Put 100 on they head, it's about time they gotta respect us. I really need a 10 if I'm signing, ain't nothing less of my mind. It gotta be special, my grind is just so excessive. They be talking down, but I don't ever let it get to me. Came to LSU my freshman year and we made history. I was trying to wait and serve the game, they wasn't tipping me. Soundtrack of my life and I'm just conducting the symphony. Ballin', this ain't winning, Billy Windows tenant, working on my image, up in my percentage. Put the pendant on the trophy, you ain't winning, don't approach me. Pull up courtside in the crazy fit, I look like Mulkey. I just hit a milli, my bank account looking silly. I'm hitting them like the Phillies, the coldest flow in the city. Like John Morant, I'm like Gritty, I've never asked for a penny. I'm blocking them like I'm Jenny, ain't no me, man, it's just Simi. I'm like, get away to hibernate, they let the beast outside the cage. Ain't try to play, they counting me out, I feel some type of way. Keep making up stories, I'm like, which one they gon' write today? Keep switching these fours, I'm like, which one I'm gon' like today? On God.
Club up, this club up. This club up, this club up. This club up, this club up.
It's
I tell them that I'm the sleaze, they telling me, okay, prove it. I lead these bitches on red, so now they know that they blew it. I tell them I'm moving units, my videos, they gon' view it. Spotify ain't gotta lie, they really streaming my music. I give the kind they fuck around and lose it. Nah, I am no wave, I only wave when I'm telling them bye. Bitch, we ain't tenant, ain't fraternal or identical. When I'm around, bitch, you know you become invisible. Who wanna play with Nicki? Got the power, I could tell my nigga spray like 50. Come on, bitch, I just put a milli on my bitchy. Mine is like 50, mine was 950.
14 remaining here from Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Harley Warlick, Tiffany Green here with you. Currently under a review of that last play as Michaela Williams dropped a three. However, they're reviewing to see if that foul, as last year Poa ran into Alberti Rimdahl, was before the shot. It was waved off. They took another look at it here, and we are getting word that the shot was no good. So the call on the floor stands here as LSU has come out swinging, a commanding lead for the defending national champs. And a conversation that you and I were having just a moment ago, Holly, was the fact that, hey, this has been excellent basketball that we've seen played by LSU.
Yeah, and it's hard because LSU's everybody's played well, but then you look at Angel Reese is still in the game and there's 5 minutes to go, and it's like you understand LSU's depth, and yeah, she has to play because Kim hadn't had a lot of experience coming in for these players.
The depth has been a question mark coming into this season after Samaya Smith went down with an injury and another player is no longer with the team, as Reese is fouled on the shot. And media timeout on the court. We'll step aside as well. Come back with us here to the PMAC.
And I know that it ain't promise, but I know I keep on grinding. And my dream gon' start aligning. And I won't stop cause I'm on my way. I just gotta keep on grinding. And it's gon' come with perfect timing. And in the end, I'm gon' be shining. And I won't quit cause I'm on my way. Yeah. And I know my day finna come, so I'm just timing it out. I just keep my head up and I'm just grinding it out. I know what I'm about, but really they just finding it out. What come with the rain, the same thing gon' come with the drought. I'm playing the game, no sleep, it got me twisting and turning. I'm living, I'm learning, feel like I've been preaching a sermon. And I thank God, yeah, cause he leave me in the dark, yeah. I stay far from him, I don't know what they
intentions in.
I'm really trying to boss up on this move, so it take discipline.
I'm being consistent this time around, that's what the difference is.
If you don't believe in your dream, what make you think they listening?
And I know that it ain't promised, but I know I keep on grinding, and my dream gon' start aligning. And I won't stop, cause I'm on my way. I just gotta keep on grinding, and it's gon' come with perfect timing. And in the end, I'ma be shining. It ain't too far, and I'm on my way. My grandma always told me, just stay prayed up. Baby, keep your grades up. They just keep them K's up. Tell me what else could save us. I'm chasing something bigger than my city, got a legacy. I'm just trying to find a newer way that I could better me. Know I got that dog inside my bones, I got that pedigree. It's times where I be stressing, I'm alone, but I can't let them see. Like, I just want my mama straight. I need that Obama cake. I just gotta find a way. I don't got no time to wait. I've been balling hard, I feel like I don't got opponents. I just walk in every single room just like I own.
And that's a bonus. Know that I'm the moment. They say they need the pieces to the puzzle, I'm the component. I know that it ain't promised, but I know I keep on grinding. And my dream gon' start aligning. And I won't stop, cause I'm on my way. I just gotta keep on grinding. And it's gon' come with perfect timing. And in the end, I'm gonna be shining. And I won't quit, cause I'm on my way.
You cannot meet a better person. Look, tough on her kids, tough on his. But hugged on him and so excited. And she got recruited by a colleague of mine, Mickey DeMoss. And how she put up with Mickey, I don't know. But so proud of Rooney and what she did. And the clean version of Lizzo, it's about dang time.
I like that. Well done. Well remixed, Holly.
Yeah. I'd like to say the real version, right. but we're on TV.
Morrow again with that offensive rebound, batted out, and then saved by Morrow, who gets to it here as a number of bodies converge on the basketball. But you see the attentiveness as wherever the ball is, you see a number of white jerseys around there as well.
Those are 50-50 plays, and as a coach, you want to win all those 50-50 plays. And for them to bounce the ball around and tip it and get it, and then they come up with it is pretty darn good.
Kelly Ray Finley, who saw her team win 5 games in SEC play a season ago, has seen a tougher sled here in this 2023-24 campaign. And hitting the century mark for the 7th time this season, the 9th-ranked LSU Tigers have done just about everything right here this afternoon. An outstanding performance. Aliyah Matharu for 3. Del Rosario cradling the basketball into the hands of Jariah Warren, and Warren is able to pick up an easy 2.
I really like that Florida's still competing. This is still a learning process, and you can learn. I know the score is so lopsided, but Florida's going to learn from this. They've done some really good things, and they just need to clean up a couple more.
Too strong there from Warren. Velez out of the Bronx, New York, up the left side of the court. Double team by the Gators, and the pressure. Bus Pipes there, coming up with the turnover. As Florida still fighting hard, as you mentioned.
Kim just, I love it. That's 3 minutes left and gets a turnover. Kim said, you got a timeout.
Yeah.
You got a timeout.
Matharu, great spin move right there as Aliyah Matharu was just so crafty. And again, getting after it defensively, caused that steal, pulls up in transition, and off the back iron.
Yeah, you got to either pull out or just take it to the basket, try to get a foul, try to get an M1 there.
Well, we've mentioned some awesome names on this broadcast. The Tiger great basketball coach, Sue Gunn. Hunter with the court honor, and That one rolls around for Del Rosario. We'll go to the line and try to complete the three-point play after this make.
Yeah, and Del Rosario just gets, just weak side, just pushes her defender under the basket and comes up with the rebound and the finish.
We talked about Rooney Scoville and Mickey DeMoss and Sue Gunter. How about Bob Starkey?
Yeah.
Who was around for those Sue Gunter days and all of those great Tiger basketball teams. And
he's their defensive guru.
Yeah.
You're talking about somebody upset about anybody questioning LSU's defense. Bob Starkey's not going to be, he's not a happy camper. He's going to be happy today.
So seeing a head coach and longtime respected basketball mind. And Faith Duke will shoot a couple. Well, coming up Tuesday night, we'll have a men's basketball doubleheader right here on the SEC Network featuring the second game. It's 10th-ranked Kentucky heading to Nashville to take on the Doors at 8:30. You can also catch it on the ESPN app. Faith Duke, one of those great stories in sports, came with the program in 2019, endured a coaching change, and stayed with it the entire time, and has been an outstanding teammate, excellent student. And too strong there from Amani Bartlett. So emptying out the bench and allowing everyone to get minutes here. We talked about the depth and defense for LSU down the stretch. Number of opportunities on the basket kept alive by the Gators. Sal gets too strong. Faith Duke comes up with the board. And that's just been indicative of the Florida Gators this game and throughout the season. Yes, the score says something completely different, but this group has not given up.
They do not give up. And this is what we were talking about most of the game, is just getting second chance points. And Florida's still battling.
And there's the Baton Rouge native, Izzy Bezelman. And the crowd inside appreciating her time on the court.
And you talk about Duke. I love that coaching change. And what do kids do this day and time? They leave. They transfer. And it says a lot about her love for Florida, her respect she has for the coaching staff. And I love that she stayed and is seeing it out.
We have seen a number of spills here.
A number.
On the court throughout this game.
Goodness. Duke got away with a little pull down.
Del Rosario. Can't see that one go down, but she'll go to the line to shoot a couple. Well, the upcoming schedule for Florida, they've got 8 games remaining after today. They'll go back home against Arkansas, then on the road at Mississippi State and round out their trip in the Magnolia State, or against the Magnolia State teams, at home against Ole Miss, Kentucky, and then Missouri.
So they've played the tough half of their schedule, and those are the teams that are a little bit in the middle of the road with them. Mm-hmm. So they'll have the opportunity to regroup and play at home and get a chance to get a win.
They'll round out the end of the month at Georgia, then Alabama, before closing out the regular season the first weekend in March against Auburn. That basket waved off by Matharu, who's been the leader for the Gators this afternoon. Here's what's next for the Tigers. They'll head to take on Shea Ralph's crew at Vanderbilt, Alabama, Texas A&M. They'll face off against Auburn again, who again upset them last month.
And
then it'll be interesting to see that matchup against Tennessee on February 25th.
Yeah, I think the Vanderbilt matchup at Vanderbilt is going to be a tough, and then at Tennessee, and the Auburn game will be interesting. LSU won't be it. They will not be happy when Auburn comes to the PMAC.
18 points on the afternoon for Aaliyah Matharu for the Gators. Izico steals it away. Matharu flips her hair casually and then puts it up and in.
Like it.
20 piece for Aaliyah Matharu. Remember, she sat out last year due to transfer rules, came over from Texas initially. Is that Mississippi State?
We weren't real sure that she was going to play today either.
They've been out with sickness for a couple of games. And she's been a lift for this group off the bench. The moves by Velez don't add any points. Alexia Dizico up ahead to Saugus. And then the foul there by Janae Kent.
Wait, like the thought?
Again, I like Florida being aggressive, not hanging their head, and working on the things they need to work on.
Remember, coming up next, folks, Mississippi State at Texas A&M. Sam Gore and Tamika Catchings will be on the call, so you'll want to stick around. Great game coming your way from College Station. Rims out. Well, this is a cause for a timeout here. A 30-second taken by Kim Mulkey as
timeout. It's definitely needed right now.
When you think about just the starters, we featured them in the open, all averaging at double figures on the season, and they fought through once again here in this ball game from both Michaela Williams and Haley Van Lith.
Yeah, they all stepped up in their own time. It was like, Morrow was on fire.
Oh, I was just crying. I don't know what happened.
Haley Van Lith had a really, really good
maybe
solid
the
game
idea
today,
of putting a vet in there with them instead of just putting them all out there at once. But
Mardi Gras season, we've got some beads here. I'm gonna give you some. I don't know if I could. I don't know if I'll be as successful as you as putting them on, but I'll just hold them up right here. They had a Mardi Gras parade here in Baton Rouge Friday.
Gore, make a play for that, please. Come on.
It's even bigger and better in New Orleans, but this region certainly just loves the feel of Mardi Gras. I didn't get any king cake. Did you?
I know. You said that.
You're flying out of New Orleans, so you'll get some.
I don't know. The little party atmosphere, I'm sure that LSU and the Tigers
they needed that. Like, you want it, here you go. And that's exactly what these girls would do to you. You think it seems as easy as how it looks with,
to catch some of the footage
who was playing
of
was
that
in.
Parade.
But look at how they was double-teaming her. Nobody was down there with her. No passes was able to get through. Multiple scores. Like, what?
Friday night heights from here. Obviously, they have an excellent gymnastics team.
Yeah.
But Nemo and company were traversing through the streets of Baton Rouge, and then they made their way into the PMAC and had a sellout crowd, 12,000 plus, the way that Tiger Nation just supports their athletic programs all the way around
in the
and the influence of the bling from Kim Mulkey. You see plays right into the Mardi Gras feel.
Kim knows.
An expression.
You can't help to think to look at what people have on this in the stands, the influence that Coach Mulkey's had on them. Mm-hmm.
And I remember her saying, hey, look, I wanted to come back and do something positive. Never thought or would have imagined it would have been all of this.
No, it's definitely
sooner.
Not too much
in
on
fact,
them, but we just
national championship.
You know what I mean? Like now our expectations get to be different. And that
LSU
is good for us all.
Louisiana,
you know?
Native herself.
So
man, just got everybody talking about LSU basketball and excited again. And home to not
I
only
know.
The women's basketball national champions,
yes,
the baseball team also won
a
national championship.
Because
they'll be back in action.
We're like, yes,
in a few weeks.
get in.
And Kim's son played
but
on the baseball
I
team.
I see, like, you know what
so
I mean?
So she's a
she how they
LSU
have
base,
to be
baseball pretty
brought into
pretty
the
close.
Game. Like, Kim's been doing
what
very good.
What I love
good.
About Kim right now is
Rosario's been doing
she's
very
still
good.
Coaching. It, there's Barlett. 18 seconds, and she's turning on the bench and talking to her players.
Yes.
And making sure that every moment is a learning moment.
Yeah.
And I also think I also think they just played the bench much harder. And you can expect them to do that too.
They
try to get their
three.
Thing off, you know what I mean?
Off the mark in the closing seconds of this one. And that does it. 106 points put up by the ninth-ranked LSU Tigers as they win big over the Florida Gators. An impressive effort. Six players in double figures for the Tigers. For Holly Warlick, I'm Tiffany Green. So long from Baton Rouge. Let's send it over to Sam Gore and Tamika Catchings from College Station.
Yes, they that played the bench harder.
Well, thank you, Tiffany and Holly. We'll let you get to celebrating Mardi Gras while we get started here in Aggieland as Texas A&M in the pink uniforms today after a week off facing Mississippi State.
Yes, she's a freshman from Bronx, New York. Of course, everybody, you're very welcome for the stream. Let me see when the next game is going to be. 2-4, should be 2-8 p.m. My daughter has just been doing stuff this entire time I've been on this stream. Okay, we play Vanderbilt on Thursday at 8 p.m. A great win. Not just another win, but a great win. We needed that.
Say it's easy. We gonna do this shit like this for the city, man. I can't do this thing called life. Put New Orleans on the fucking map. Throw your ones up. Alright. One time. You gotta rock your hips. Rock your hips. You gotta rock your hips. Rock your hips. You gotta rock your hips. Rock your hips. You gotta rock your hips. Like this for the city, man.
Yeah, we gonna have to watch that post game. I know they gonna ask her about how she felt about what it looked like when the bench was out there. We gonna see. Thank you guys. Thank you, thank you. We'll be back on Thursday at 8 p.m. Love you guys more. Exactly. They was not playing that hard, double teaming them, blah, blah, blah. And that was because of the respect level, I feel like, you know? Oh, my. I'm so happy we bounced back today. Great win. Great win. Yeah, we did discuss the comments in the last post. Basically, I went live for like an hour before the game and just watched Coach Mulkey and everything she's been talking about. But the game really spoke for itself. Like, let me pull up the numbers. The game looked great on defense. The game looked great on offense. Obviously, they were able to score over 100 points. But yeah, you'll hear a lot of talk about this game. Great bounce back win for them.
Hurry to Kohl's for clearance and closeout deals you don't want to miss. Save up to 70% while you still can on top finds like
yes. Good game PJs, for now.
Jeans, sweaters, and so much more. Find your faves for low prices at Kohl's.
Okay. Look, from what we saw last year, winning the national championship, as that one was a nice feed in and out for Reeves, but relentless on the boards. And
okay, guys. Well, great game. Let me know when you guys want to come back. Thursday at 8 p.m. is going to be our next game. Have you a nice drink. Enjoy your Sunday. Everybody be safe. Where do you... Y'all let her know. I think we go outside of the top 10 is what the expectations have been, even if we were to win today's game. Oh, no. Mommy and Charmy and Daddy is back. See you guys Thursday. Thank you, guys. Double digits for all the starters. Nothing new. I love today's game, though. It seems so much more comfortable with POA and HVL in. It worked very, very smoothly. Michaela's shots were able to hit Anissa and Angel. And then when Flage was playing, Flage was hitting all her shots. Where's the... I don't know. Great flow. I figured 12-13. Yeah. And I have been, I went back to watch her old highlights and stuff, and that's why I've had that level of expectation for her. For me, I feel like a lot of it is psychological. When you are from Bronx, New York, and you move to Baton Rouge, Louisiana, that is a huge difference. When you're a freshman, when you're 18, 19 years old, and you guys can say that that doesn't play a factor, but it definitely does. We're all human at the end of the day, whether we play a sport or not. So I feel like that plays an effect. I can see it. I feel like we all can see it. And nerves just get to you. Yes, make sure you guys say happy birthday to Anissa. She just turned 21. Exactly. And that's the other thing too, player development. We would love to see that. Yep, make sure you subscribe. We always stream all the games. And there's nowhere in the world like New York City. There's nowhere in the world like Bronx, Brooklyn. Okay, she's 22. Okay. Thank you. But okay, cool. Is there anything you guys want to talk about in a post game? We can do it while we're on here before I end it. And then I'm going to go on with the rest of my Sunday. Yeah, so they're commented right here how you are commenting on YouTube. We also stream on Twitter for about half of the game. I'm actually going to go ahead and take down Twitter now. And then I just posted up. She's 21. I know. I'm a New Yorker. I'm from upstate. But I feel like there is an adjustment period. But I feel like if she does get it going, she's going to be great. If she does, when she does get it going, because I believe she'll go somewhere, even if it's not LSU, and make something happen. It's still on the same stream. I had only did one stream today. I got to see that clip again because I didn't even get, I was looking more so towards the ball and what was going on towards the ball. So I didn't see everybody behind. So I got to see that again. Kim would be crazy to keep. Wesley. Yep. Poa was real for that. Will you be streaming? Yes. Yes, of course. We're going to be streaming it all. Now, listen, the thing is we are also on playback .tv. So YouTube is not really where I want to stream the games from now on, but I is still, you know, transferring everything over and getting more people to know about playback. Because what playback, I did a meeting with them, and what they offer is like where it doesn't get interrupted. You guys know how YouTube takes down our streams. It won't get interrupted there. You'll be able to comment. You can, like, it's very cool over there. I like it. The only thing it doesn't have right now is the overlays, and I really like how we have the banners that come up, our backgrounds. I like certain features about StreamYard that they don't have right now, so I'm kind of still figuring out, like, how to do both of them. But playback.tv is where we're going to be streaming the NCAA tournament, because I know YouTube is going to take it down. So I'm going to be making sure I'm keeping to notify you guys about playback. Kim makes a lot of money. So yeah, you can watch today's game on playback. I did stream it there. Playback is playback.tv/GoTigerHoops. And if some of you guys stay on, I will share something with you guys. Okay, it's also in the description of this video. Yeah, it's because I'm messing up right now. Okay, this is the right link, the last one that I posted. playback.tv/GoTigerHoops. Okay. So I wanted to share this with you guys. So basically, this platform that God has given us is just something that we started in like November. I was speaking with him about it after watching basically what Colorado Buffaloes did. So Colorado Buffaloes, Deion Sanders, when they went to Colorado, it became this big, big, huge media like firestorm. And everybody was talking about the team, and his son has Well Off Media. That's like this huge media company. They also have two other ones. So it was like, and then I would see all these small YouTubers that was streaming the game, that was posting, talking about it, blah, 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 blah. So it was so much about it. But by the time I was seeing it, it was already like middle of the season type thing. So I went to my husband. I was talking to him about maybe doing something like that, but for next year for them. But I was like, but people love, and I already loved LSU. So I was like, let's try it for LSU. And he agreed, blah, blah, blah. But based on my background, I already knew Canva, I already knew streaming, I use computers, all that type of stuff all the time, worked in call centers, you know, we own the cleaning business now, but I just used my background and integrated it with this, and God put his wind on it to be at 2,000 subscribers in just a few months. All these people in the chat that we truly love, they come back each and every time. Like, I know their names. They know us. We're talking about, it just feels like such a good community. It's such a beautiful thing, truly. So to have the platform, it's like, how do you use it? What information do you share? what are you talking about? Even the music that you play, because I listen to certain music in my real life that maybe is not the music that I play on the streams all the time, because it's maybe something that people want to hear. That's why I include the songs like Evidence or Wonder, like the Christian songs that I truly do listen to in my real life, to incorporate what I feel God has given me the platform for. So one of the things that I've been hearing about is to share this information with you guys, which is basically the federal government. So this is for my U.S. people. I know a lot of people are from overseas as well, but this is for my U.S. people. The federal government gave a grant to Arizona University for the AZ Next program, and it's to help people get tech jobs, tech careers, certifications. It is all free, and they do offer different programs. So they have like cybersecurity, Google IT certificate, ServiceNow administrator. They have advanced, they have all these different programs. And it is something that I wanted to share with you guys. If anybody is interested, you can contact them directly. I will leave the link in the description and in the comments right now. And it's definitely a good program if you guys are interested. I want to make sure I'm using this platform to edify and uplift and actually encourage and motivate people, along with watching the game, because I do want the platform to be about more than just that, on a community level of actually sharing things that help each other in the comments. So I'm gonna leave that here. I know we were talking about the post game, but I did feel led to just share this with you guys. Like this program right here, this is a program that can help you learn coding. And look at the average salary. This is a free program. There's a link to application. You must be 17 years or older, a high school or GED graduate, eligible to work in the U.S. And this one, so this programming language experience requirement, this is another thing that you can do. You can go to Fiverr.com. I'm not sure if you guys know about this website, but Fiverr.com is somewhere where you can learn basically a lot of different things. People can make you websites and things like that. So this is OOMP programming. And coding and cybersecurity and all these things with tech are going to help you get a higher paying salary and actually are positioning yourself for the future. So if you know how to code, if you want to become a project manager, if you want to do anything in IT security, these are all really, really good, you know, jobs and career paths. Tech is the New Black on YouTube is the person that I watch and I like to follow. So right here, this person, and there's a whole bunch of different people, but I'm gonna just show you guys this as an example. You can pay $20 for a 30-minute session with them on learning one of these. There's people that you have to look on here, because I saw somebody for like $25, it would be 7 one-hour sessions. I think I did save it. But it's things like that that you can use that are super, super cool. So, yeah, like Midjourney, if you guys seen everything that's happening with AI, if you guys have seen everything happening with like Gag City, all of those things are super, super cool. You can start like an Etsy page using Midjourney like a pro. Like, I mean, you can pay somebody $35 to help you do it. So these are just things that we can share in our community that, you know, can help each other. So that's all I did want to share with that. Yes, Well Off Media playback. I just came back over to the comments, guys. Yeah, not that coding is for everybody, but you never know who it is for. It could be even one person on here that coding is for. That would be a beautiful thing. Thank you so much. AI is definitely coming in the future. Fiverr is cool. Exactly. I love Fiverr too. So I'll leave that link there for you guys. Was there anything else y'all wanted to talk about with the team? Big, big win for LSU today. Big, big win for LSU today. Let me see the comments. Happy birthday, Anissa Morrow. Thank you. You're very welcome. So did you guys like, yeah, I was just going to ask about that. HBO showing out at the two was huge. And I bet you that felt so good for her. I literally bet you that felt so good for her to be able to just cook in her position. Like, oh, I know that. Look at her. I told you. Aw. Like, that's what she's been waiting for, bro. Look at that smile. I know. Anissa had her a game today, too. Let me see if they're there yet. If they're there, Corey Diaz is going to post. Okay.
Physicality to the game. She's very versatile, you know, at that forward position. They can move her around a lot. I think she complements what they do from an inside-out perspective very, very well. But she's also very unselfish. She's unselfish. She attacks the glass. She'll go get that ball herself. And so she does. She definitely has brought a different dimension to their team as a whole. Yeah, you know, Morrow brings a tremendous amount of physicality to the game. She's very versatile, you know, at that forward position. They can move her around a lot. I think she complements what they do from an inside-out perspective very, very well. But she's also very unselfish. She's unselfish. She attacks the glass. She'll go get that ball herself. And so she does. She definitely has brought a different dimension to their team as a whole. Yeah, you know. She compliments what they do from an inside out.
That was beautiful. That's so true. Yes. They said, don't put it on me. We, girl, that was you. Aw, let me see. Missed you, Smith. Wow. Today's games marks the most points LSU has scored in an SEC game since 2004. Fire. Now I feel really bad. Now I feel really, really bad. Definitely this show. Well, the post-game presser is usually uploaded maybe like an hour after the game. Do I know what our bench points were today? Let me see. Okay. Yeah, she did. It worked out good, so I think she'll keep going with it. Morrow had 18 points, 20 rebounds. I think that's because Flage had fell, you know, somebody had fell on her. I'm not sure why I can't see it how I usually do. Yeah, I know. I hope she does have a post-game presser. Maybe her and Morrow. Okay, here comes my baby girls, guys. So I'm going to hop off. It was a great game. Thank you guys all for watching with us. We will be back on Thursday at 8 p.m. And I hope you guys have a great rest of your day. Thank you. Good night. Hi, Charlie.